Grabbing it. Yeah.
I That happened to me for the coyote, but I just like, you know, I don't eat, there's a lot of food here. I just kept eating.
He doesn't want to eat.
Oh, man. All right, we'll get the open.
I got heavy static too.
Yeah. Heavy static.
A little bit of static. Well, why don't we do a recording and then see what it sounds like?
Corcoran? Yeah. Cork? Like pop a cork.
Really? Pop the top again. I think Corcoran. I'll have another round.
Oh, it's the double C, Corcoran.
Well, how's it? Here, let's just try it and see what everybody has to say. Corcoran. We'll do it live.
I don't know. That's a lot of static. It seems very.
Is yours
like
loud?
A lot of electricity flowing through here.
Oh, I guess I'm okay.
Ooh, it's on this one.
Are you fixing it?
No.
Oh, mine reduced. Oh, no, it's back.
It's in that. That's what it is.
What's in what?
It's in there. It's in that. That's what it is.
It's here! Well, if it sounds good on your end.
Oh, I can hear that.
Wait, are we live? Hey, everybody, we're live. We're not, I repeat, not in any kind of technical difficulties. I'm Matt Omekin for the Hornet's Nest. Sitting alongside me is Wade Omekin. And welcome. We're here in C-Town live for Level 1 or Division 5 Level 1 playoff play. I don't have anything for you. Ross Patterman from the Tribune Phonograph, former Tribune Phonograph. He won the coveted Colby Community Award.
Oh, yes. That's
and
right.
We had to fix it because we misspelled his name. Did you know he has two N's in Patterman?
No. He's Who like would an, put two in there?
It's insane. So we had to add an extra N.
Seems
and
excessive.
I said, hey, come here Friday and I'll have it for you. And guess what happened? I did not bring it.
Fact.
I know. I know, and you have a Facebook account. That's what makes it more embarrassing. But anyway, let's talk about this football game real quick. So here we are. Colby has the benefit of having a home football game. They're seeded number 4, taking on number 5, GET, the Gale Ederick Trempolo Redhawks. So now, this would beg the question, like anybody would ask, who the hey who are the GETs? They come out of the Cooley region, which... Wade, where's the Cooley region?
So the Cooley region actually extends pretty much on that western side of the state. It's more of like a driftless area where the
yes.
Cooleys would be, where the glacial uh-huh. kind of butted up against you as the water flowed away from the glacier, left these small depressions off it, but didn't remove all the rock.
It's a beautiful region.
Beautiful, beautiful. That's
I've
what
seen
most
pictures.
Of Wisconsin used to be. We used to be a tall mountain range flowing right through the middle of the state. All gone.
I know. Isn't that nuts? Now we're just this level, flattened playing field of trees and farm fields.
Still pretty.
It's you're right. It's all still pretty. But anyway, that's where they hail out of. So that Cooley Conference, real quick, in conference play, GET is coming into here at 5-2. So they dropped two losses within conference play. But... they ended the season at 5-4. And then Colby is actually 8-1 in conference play. They took one conference loss, and that was
right.
against Auburndale last week. So somebody could say, like, well, GET, they're 5-4. Listen, they only have two conference losses to our one conference loss. And if you want to put this even into more context, they are in a conference where they have West Salem, which is playing Division III playoffs right now at number one seed. So they took a loss from them. And they have they play against Aquinas, which is number one seed in Division V. So they got a pretty stout conference.
Wow.
We got a pretty competitive conference, but they got a really competitive conference. So now, wait, did you do any research on these teams?
No.
Okay, so let me keep talking. So let me keep talking for you. So Colby is coming into the season just under 2,500 yards rushing with 35 touchdowns total on the season. You know, didn't quite get to 600 yards passing, but and sitting at 9 touchdowns. GET, get this, Wade, 28, almost 2,800 yards rushing, 35 touchdowns, almost 400 yards passing, 5 touchdowns.
Only 400 yards passing?
Yes.
They are throwing pretty much the entire worm up here.
Right. So, is this a prelude to something?
Oh.
So, their defense is, which is really fascinating, so their defense has 12 interceptions on the season. So I imagine that they got a defense where it's like, we're going to ground and pound and wear out this defense, and then offenses have to pass against us to beat us. So they got 12 interceptions. Colby, same thing. They got 16. Tackles for losses, though, they're sitting somewhere in like the lower 30s. We're at a whopping 58.
Wow.
So basically what I'm trying to tell everybody here is that you have two juggernaut running offenses at the top of their game in their conferences, even though they have two losses in their conference. Colby's one, and Colby's co-champions of the Merriwood. But you got two stout running teams, and you got to imagine that their front lines and their linebacker core are going to be pretty stout as well. So what does that mean? Are we going to see a lot of razzle-dazzle on the ground with the running game? Maybe, maybe not, which must mean that teams are going to naturally want to say, like, well, let's see if we can spread this out. Let's see if we can pass.
Right. Well, I would, you know, obviously I would assume that they were watching some of the opponents that gave Colby a hard time this year, because there was only a few.
They probably watched Pittsville. They probably watched Auburndale. And those were probably the only two tapes that they watched.
Right.
If it was me.
400 yards on the season. It will be surprising to see how much they throw, because that has been Colby's Achilles heel in defense this year.
And I think the word is out, and I got to imagine that if you're GET, you're coming into this game of like, listen, we're not going to try any home run balls, but maybe we will if we see a one-on-one matchup that we really like. And maybe we'll just try to get this Colby defense spread out a little bit, and then we'll get them on their back heels, and then let's see if we can open up that run game when
right.
everybody spreads out.
But do you
out.
Stick to what you're good at, or do you stick to what should work against your opponent?
See, and then that's what,
yeah.
Right. So, like, do you just abandon what got you here?
Right.
I don't think you do. So I think the first quarter, I wouldn't be surprised if you see two or three breakout running plays on either side here. Like, maybe Hamer springs loose, scampers for 30. Maybe Caden Healy finally gets it to the outside, shrugs a few people off. But I gotta imagine that GET...
Play-action pass. It's gonna happen. First quarter. It's mm-hmm. gonna happen.
Yeah. I gotta imagine that. So, this is gonna be an interesting game.
Ooh.
For both the... For everybody that's watching this. Even for, like, the GET and Colby fandom. Like, you never have a bad game when you have a number four pitting against a number five. So, want to welcome everybody here. We're 1 minute away. So, I'm the PA announcer here at Colby. And so, I'm going to bug out here. Wade's going to take over a little bit along with Neil. And we'll catch up with you later.
All right. Well, in about 50 seconds, we're going to be doing the Star Spangled Banner here.
I guess I got to talk with Wade now.
Well, you could ask for more perfect conditions tonight. It is a balmy, probably 60 degrees out here, dead calm, not a cloud in the sky. And the stands, we're at about standing room only here for the Colby stands up here. So we're probably sitting at around like 300-400 people out here. All right, and with that, it is Star Spangled Banner time here.
Gentlemen, welcome to Colby Hornet Field here in Colby, Wisconsin, home of Wisconsin's only original cheese and your Colby Hornets. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask you to focus your gaze to the flag at the scoreboard, and please rise if you are able. Remove your hats and place your hand over your heart as we honor America and those defending our freedom with the playing of our national anthem by the Colby High School Band under direction of Mrs. Huss. Thank you. here we go. Welcome once again to Colby, Wisconsin for tonight's Division 5, Level 1 playoff matchup between the GET Redhawks. As they face the Colby Hornets. Let's meet tonight's starting lineups, beginning with GET. For the visiting Redhawks, as a symbol of unity, GET has chosen to be introduced as a team. Together as one, Redhawks strong. Here are your 2022 GET Redhawks. And here are your Colby Hornets. Starting on offense, number two, Tevin Rue. Number four, Tucker Meyer. Number five, Caden Weezy. Number 21, Caden Healy. Number 32, Ivan Hamer. Number 54, Oscar Zamora. Number 55, Tucker Bros. Number 56, Grant Ulrich. Number 71, Braxton Meyer. Number 71, Logan Stitchin. And number 84 in your programs, Nathaniel Robida. And your head coach, Jim Hagan, assisted by Robbie Spazzo, Logan Rosemeyer, Jimmy Flint, John Fleischman, and Henry Sanchez. Tonight's officials, provided by WIAA, is Bob Howitz, Steve Hirschbaumer, Jim Halas, Jim Haluska, Derek Joziak, and Sam Sear.
Oh man, I'm glad I got that out of my system.
Wow.
Ooh, welcome. What's that? Yeah, they'll get it. Well, welcome back, everybody.
They're fine. All right. The Red Hawks will be kicking off to Kobe here.
So Wade is my spotter. So how this works is I two-time it. So I got two microphones. So I got the one that's wrapped around my head and in front of my mouth, and then I got one that's kind of like a PA announcer. So Wade looks around and says, hey, I think this guy's got the ball.
That guy could too. Who knows?
GET is set to kick off. Colby back to receive.
Oh, Robita and Healy back there tonight.
GET finally says, okay, guys, spread out. Give me some room.
All right.
Number 12 is going to get set to kick it off for GET.
Knox.
That's Dominic Knott.
Knott.
Checking over
right.
Everybody. And he says, I am not going to kick this short. And we're underway. Level 5, or Division 5, Level 1
Robita.
Is underway. Robita is going to get the ball. Finds a seam. Busts it loose.
Uh-oh.
Breaks a tackle. He's across the 50. Nobody's going to catch him. He's at the 10, the 5, touchdown, Colby!
Oh, he went through like two defenders' hands, all arm tackles. No one touched him.
He had a seam, and he put on the Jets. Oh, look at that handsome flag down there, Wade. Made by Premier Printing. Donated by the Hornets.
That is a very fancy flag there.
Yeah, not going to brag. Designed it myself.
Oh, looks like Bros is lining up with Wheezy holding for Colby.
This Colby fandom is jacked up, supercharged. Snap looks good. Bros up the middle. You know it's good. Colby strikes first on the opening kickoff. 11 minutes and 49 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Lots of ball game to go yet. Hornets strike first. GET, zero.
I know that I can handle schooling my children because RVA provides the tools that I need. The RVA has adjusted curriculum by placing children right where their learning is. That's the number one goal, is to make sure that your children are learning. And so you don't move on if they haven't grasped the concept. You stop, pause, and you make sure that you grasp that before you move on. The RVA will work with your child's needs and will provide the support and the attention that your child not only needs but deserves.
Are you ready for a faster and easier mortgage process? Tap Lending combines the speed and efficiency of technology and people and a great local bank. The perfect combination for your mortgage.
All right. What do we got back to receive here? Got 8 and 6, it looks like.
Ceiling. Enhance it back to receive.
Deep kick.
Ceiling is just going to let it bounce into the end zone, and it's going to be a touchback. And that is where, at the 20-yard line, where the Redhawks are going to get to work.
8.8 miles per hour.
Bro's kickoff goal is...
Yeah, I know. We got to do it miles per hour, though.
...roll the rest of the way, and that's going to be a touchback. Bringing the ball to the 20-yard line, that's where the Redhawks are going to get to work. First and 10, GET.
So here we go, the much anticipated first offensive play for the Redhawks, and it's going to be a formation that's really similar to Abbotsford and to Colby. It's a tight formation.
29 in motion.
Going into motion.
Quarterback keeper.
And not going to find much daylight.
3.
Cody Schmitz on the carry.
Healy on the tackle.
A lot of room, maybe a half a yard. Second down.
Schmitz on the carry. Healy on the stop. About a half yard gain. Second down.
He spun right into that defense there. There was everybody waiting for him. Everybody was watching that 29, but with no toss, he abandoned it pretty early.
You know, that's the double-edged sword with this bunch formation is, man, it makes it really easy to get blown up. But you create such confusion because you don't know where that ball is going to be. Just like right now, it rolls off to the right-hand side, and they're going to bring it about a solid 4-yard gain.
Zero on the
Agent
carry.
Zero. Wow. I've been wanting to say that.
Yep.
Warren Stoner
Wheezy
with a great
on the
run.
Tackle.
Third and 5 for GET.
Wheezy on the tackle.
Agent Zero, Stoner on the carry. Wheezy on the stop. Third down.
So if Robita really ran that 96 yards in 11 seconds, he was technically running 18 miles per hour.
Oh, my God. Here's the snap.
Quarterback keeper.
He rolls it out.
Oh,
Healy. First down,
Healy
and the flag
and
gets thrown. He's close to that first down marker, but it looks like he's going to be about a yard or two short.
It might be holding. Voss got kind of pushed in the back there, it looked like.
Schmitz on the carry. Flag on the play.
Holding. Number 14. Offense. 10-yard penalty. Still third down.
Voss came around Voss came around that backside there and got kind of blocked in the back and kind of grabbed on that portion. I'm sure that's where that penalty came from.
Sure.
Meyer and Healy on that initial tackle, though.
Colby fandom, while the older crowd in the middle here is just kind of waiting patiently, the student section on their feet, dressed out in camouflage and blaze orange. It must be camo night.
Fumble.
Oh, and the ball is on the ground, and Colby tries to bounce on it, but it's going to maintain possession for the Redhawks. Woo, that was a close one. That was a pitch to number 29, Ceiling.
Yep, and he fumbled it on the ground. Domer was the first guy to him.
Goes to Ceiling, and the ball hits the turf, but it maintains possession for the Redhawks. Fourth down.
All right, so you got Rue and Robita back to receive for Colby, and you've got, still the same kicker, number 12 there, not with the punt.
No. 12, not. Oh, and a flag gets thrown. Not says, not
so
on that kick.
Zero might have been facing towards the line of scrimmage on that motion. You can't be running forward.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yes.
Good ball. 5-yard penalty. Both start offense. Still fourth down.
You know, that guy's taking, he said enough. I'm not going to say anything.
So it's like arena football, where you come running forward on the line of scrimmage. You just,
sure.
You can't do that. You can go run parallel, but you can't run forward. So he turned the corner waiting for that snap, and the snap was just kind of delayed.
I gotcha. Wow. Deep into the playbook. Not. Takes. Oh, it takes a favorable bounce. Almost gets to the 45.
Probably should have grabbed that ball.
46. Yeah, Rue let it drift.
It's actually a really good punt.
That's where Kobe's gonna
deep
get
into his own end zone. That's what up? You're 50. Oh, he's probably 5 yards back. That's probably a 54-yard punt.
Takes a favorable bounce and lands at the 46-yard line, and that's where the Hornets are going to get to work. First down, Colby.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad punt.
No, he was
especially in high school terms. Here's their first offensive series for the Hornets. Meyer under center.
Hamer.
And it's going to be Hamer time. He goes up the middle. Hard fought 6 yards, 5 yards on the play.
I'd give it to second down. Nate Schneider on the tackle.
Hamer on a 5 yard carry.
Nate Schneider on the tackle.
Schneider on the stop. Second down.
Hamer is new to the season. He was a backup of a backup, but with Lopez out for the season, Hamer's going to get some serious touches.
Healy,
sit, cut, lowers his shoulder, but he gets thumped.
Stoner.
Big Hilton, Hilton. Stoner. He's about a yard short from the first down marker, third down.
Healy on the carry, just short of that first down marker. He gets Hilton. Thumped by Ben Hilton. Third down and short.
That was a big tackle.
By Hilton?
Yeah.
No joke.
Both of them running full speed there. That was
a
very big,
Healy
big tackle.
Healy up like a wallet. Here we go. He's going to hear the hand up the
Healy
middle.
Right up
Healy's going to fight for it. He must have heard that wallet joke, and he picks up that first down. Colby keeps chain gang moving.
Carter Rappel? Rappel? Rappel?
Healy on the carry, gets a pass, the first down marker. First down, Colby.
17 on the tackle.
Number 17, Rappel on the stop.
Rappel, okay.
Meyer gets the...
Rue coming around the corner.
Hands it off to Rue. Turns the corner. Spin move. Runs into a lot of traffic. Tries to get some blocks from Healy, but there's just way too many red jerseys.
Rappel on the initial stop.
And it's going to be a big, hefty carry, about a six-yard carry. Oh, man. Tim Carl, who donated the sound system for the Hornets
here. They're
like
cookie monsters
up
here.
Thank you. Six-yard carry
by Rue. Second down.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
Yeah, from Carl Construction. He's a good cat. Hamer gets the handoff.
Oh,
gets wrapped around the neck and brought down. No call. About a 2 yard gain. It looks like about like
Yikes.
A third and two for the Hornets.
72, Haney on the
Hamer
tackle.
On the carry.
72, Haney.
Number 72, Haney on the stop. Third down and short for the Hornets.
I don't think that he got inside that shirt color. I think that was a legal tackle there. He just kind of spun him around aggressively.
Robita at the top, I formation. It's going to go to Healy up the middle. Gets some blockers and lowers his whoa, a guy literally landed on top of his shoulders. Blast,
he carried
him. First down marker. First down, Colby again.
Number 9, Will Mack on the tackle. Healy on the carry.
Healy on the carry. He's going to move that chain gang. First down, Colby.
Do you think that's smoke or do you think that's a cloud?
That is definitely smoke. Maybe it's a grease fire.
Healy, right up the gut.
Healy shrugs off one tackler, spins out of another one, but he's going to run out of real estate. But he's going to pick up a hefty 5 yard gain. That's going to be a second down for the Hornets.
Lakey, number 52.
Yeah, number 52 finally bringing him to a stop.
Healy on the carry. Lakey finally brings it to a stop. Second down and 5 to go for the Hornets.
What do you got, Lakey?
Lakey?
I don't know.
Yeah, there seems to be a lot of... There is a definite haze coming over the field now.
It's
Meyer
a pass.
Drops back to pass. Gets it to Hamer. Gets it by his fingertips. Great turn and grab. Big game for the Hornets. It's going to be right about at the 15-yard line, deep in Red Hawk territory. First down, Colby.
Brady Sealing on the tackle, number 29.
Meyer connects with Hamer for a big gain.
Brady Sealing, number 29.
Number 29, Sealing on the stop. First down, Colby.
Sealing had good coverage there. He was right behind him.
Hey,
Aaron
give it
made
for the Red
very
Hawks here, though.
Good tackle
not,
there.
Give it for the Red Hawks here, though. They are not
Hamer.
Letting any of these plays blow up on him.
55.
55 with a big stop.
Robertson.
Robertson blasts through the line and says, not today.
2 yard loss. Hamer on the carry.
Hamer on the carry, number 55.
Robinson.
Justin Robinson with a big stop. Second down.
That was a big play. You know why? That's what the Redhawks needed right now. They needed to kind of back up Colby just a little bit. Handoff goes Healy. To Healy. Shreds a couple of tackles. Tries to fight through a third one. And he gently gets brought down at the 5 yard line.
55 again. Robinson had him by the.
Healy on the carry. Robinson brings him down just short of the first down marker. Third down.
Had him by the shoelaces pretty much the whole time. He carried him a couple of yards and then finally brought him down.
Yeah, Robinson, big time playing
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, he is absolutely everywhere. Third
Robinson
and short
is,
for Colby here.
He's a senior outside linebacker line. Colby lining up. Looking to see if they can punch this into the end zone.
Looks like
see
they're
if they
showing
can get
blitz.
Another score. Handoff.
Hamer
up
right
the
up the gut.
Hamer!
He might.
Gets stopped and he's going to lean over. And
oh, they put him right on the
edge line. Just shy of the goal line. Big stop there by Redhawks, just by the skin of their teeth.
Hamer on the carry. Jimenez. Jimenez, number 70
Jimenez
on the tackle.
Stopping him short off the goal line. First and goal, Colby.
Him and like five of his buddies stopped them about on the inch yard line here.
Yeah, no kidding.
First and goal. Hamer right up the gut.
Hamer goes in and he doesn't even get knocked over. Touchdown, Colby.
Offensive line pushes, and Hamer gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Colby.
Wow, what a series there. Colby just grinding it out and finally hits pay dirt with a touchdown by Hamer.
It's awful quiet without music behind these touchdowns here.
Well, see what happens, Wade, is, well, hold on. Wheezy, hold, good, laces out. Roast up to the right, and it's good.
Ed Finkel's the mayor.
Yeah, Ed Finkel's the mayor. 4 minutes and 21 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Colby strikes again. GET 0, the Hornets 14.
Hey everybody, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
Insurance of Northern Wisconsin is your qualified, experienced team for custom insurance packages for your vehicle, your home, and your family. At Klinner Insurance, protecting your family is our top priority. Klinner Insurance.
Six and eight. Back
here
to
we go.
Seat.
Colby set to kick it off to Ceiling. Ball goes up into the air, and Ceiling backs up and says, nah. I ain't taking that. Goes it back at the end zone. Touchback.
Gross boots it to the back of the end zone. And it's going to be another touchback. Bringing the ball out to the 20-yard line. Redhawks going to get set to work. First and 10, GET.
So I was going to say something. Then I lost my train of thought. But now, as I ramble on more, it's come back.
All right, what is it?
That was a big offensive series for the Hornets, especially coming off with the stalling that they had against Auburndale. But what a response.
Two.
Agent number two, Schindler, up the middle, not going to find much, and it gets gobbled up by that Colby Hornet defense. Just tough going for the Redhawks so far in their running game.
Domer
second
on the
down.
Initial stop there, but pretty much everybody else on the tackle.
Schindler on the carry.
Domer
on the initial stop. Second down.
So in case you missed it, the Redhawks are coming into this game a running-heavy team, and why not? 35 touchdowns on the season, matching up with the Colby Hornets, and they actually have more yardage rushing on the season than the Colby Hornets on fewer carries. So
keeper.
They might be breaking it out. And right here, the quarterback tries a stiff arm, but he finally gets roped out of bounds. Meyer
by
does
the other
not
quarterback.
Let him go. Big gain there by Cody Schmitz. Finally moves that chain gang first down for the Red Hawks of the game.
Meyer on the tackle.
Schmitz on the carry, and he moves that chain gang. First and 10, Red Hawks. Meyer on the stop.
It was like he was shaking his hand, just trying to get him out of bounds.
I know, he's just like, no.
Hey,
let go. No.
Why don't you go out of bounds here?
GET fandom is coming alive. Their student section is standing up.
Two on the carry.
Oh, shreds a first tackle. Schindler finally gets it past the 45-yard line. Uh-oh, here come the Red Hawks. Another first down.
Wheezy on the tackle. Two on the carry, Wheezy
Schindler
on the...
Schindler on the carry, moves that chain gain again. First and 10, GET. Wheezy finally bringing up to a stop.
Well, I think they found their sign. They've had some success coming low side of your screen here.
Goes in motion, and it's going to be handoff. It's going to go on the right-hand side again. Healy knocks him over and finally finished off.
77.
By Stitchin. And that was Schindler on the carry.
Schindler on the carry, Stitchin, and Healy on the stop. Second down.
Yeah, they like that right side. They're exploiting something over there.
So on that right, or on that, is it the left or the right?
Well,
right,
it would be, the it would be their heads. Right. Yeah, okay, so they're trying to run away from Domer and Rue on that outside.
Yep, so it's Wheezy and Voss is who they're running at. Now they're going to try it up the middle and not much going, but they're going to pick up 3 yards, and that's going to bring up a third down and manageable for the Red Hawks.
Rue on the tackle.
Schindler on the carry, picks up a couple, and it's brought down by Rue, bringing up a third down and manageable for the Red Hawks.
Yeah, so what I was going to say before, everybody's kind of used to when the Colby Hornets score, you play the fight song, but being that that's his playoff play, no favoritism. So you can't do it.
Even if we had their fight song?
Nobody ever gave me their fight song. And it goes up the middle, shakes a couple of people loose, and leans over, and he's going to be right on that first down marker. If not, just, he's going to be a football length short.
Stoner on the carry, Rotz on the tackle.
Agent Zero, Stoner on the carry, and he's just short of that first down marker. Fourth down.
Rotz on the tackle.
Rotz on the stop.
To me, it looked like he leaned over, but the refs must have saw that his knee must have been down first.
Well, Rotz was on the backside of his ankles. Actually, Rotz came up a little limpy on that last one.
So, really?
Yeah, he must have got the cleats into his guts on that initial fall down. So, yeah,
his knees did. Have you ever had cleats to the gut? Not great.
Not two stars.
Trying to draw the Hornets off sides. Finally,
the quarterback
is going to lean over, and he's going to pick up the first down and much more. Schmitz leaning on that offensive line that they got, and they push that pile. First down, Red Hawks.
Do you give the tackle to Domer because he was on the bottom of the pile?
Schmitz picks up the first down, and now move the chain gang. First and 10, GET.
I'd give it to Domer.
Domer on the stop.
He was on the bottom of the pile. Everybody was stepping on him. He was technically touching him the first and the last. So.
Colby not able to respond to this big surge by the Red Hawks.
29.
He's going to 29, and he's going to try to go on the left side and gets gobbled up. It's going to be about a yard or two gain for the Red Hawks.
Ceiling on the carry, Rotz on the tackle.
Number 29, ceiling on the carry, Rotz bringing him to a stop. Second down.
47 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. It's amazing that this is still the first quarter. And time is actually
not for very much longer. 35 seconds.
Yeah, we're nearing 30 seconds away, and time is tick, 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 ticking. Red Hawks looking to see if they can get on the scoreboard, see if they can get back into the
quarterback
fight.
Keeper.
Number 3 is going around the left, makes a couple of people miss it. Finally, gets roped down. About a 6-yard gain.
Wow, where'd the ball go?
2 yards short. Ball. Oh, and the ball
was
a
fumble.
Fumble by the Hornets.
He was getting spun by Stitchin. And during that time, his butt or his knees wasn't down, and that ball came out.
Schumitz on the carry, but the Hornets get the fumble. Turnover. Hornets back on offense. First down, Colby.
I think everybody was expecting him to be down, but he was laying on top of Stitchin.
So who ripped it out?
So Stitchin spun him around, but he spun him around right on top of him. And as he came out, one of the guys put his knees up, and the football hit that knee, and it just squirted out.
Unbelievable. Big stop by the Hornets just when the Red Hawks were getting something rolling. Meyer going to hand it off to
Healy,
and he's going to go on the far sideline. Flag down. gets some blocking.
That might
gets
be a block
it to the first
the
down marker at the 45-yard line, but there's a flag down.
Ceiling, number six on the tackle.
Healy on the carry, gets it to the 45-yard line, but there's a flag on the play.
I think it's going to be a block in the back. As he come around that corner, it might have been even stitching, pushing on the backside.
And if you can hear it, the GET fandom is ecstatic. That usually means that the other team had a penalty.
10-yard penalty, still first down.
Yeah, you heard the guy.
Well, and the only way you can hear him is from those. That's a wonderful donation that we got for
Tim Carl's got a great construction company. Had a couple of kids go through this program. We owe him a lot.
Rue on the carry.
Rue busts through!
Ceiling debate.
He's going to try to get it to the 45-yard line, but he puts on the speed.
That was quite the tricky play. That was a fake pitch run up the gut to Rue.
What a great play.
Ceiling on the tackle.
Rue on the carry and busts three through the defense. It gets it short, just short of the 45-yard line. First down, Colby. And that is going to be the end of the first,
the end of the first quarter.
Well, that's what I was about to say. And it's the end of your first quarter. Redhawks 0, your Hornets 14.
I absolutely feel that Tiger Lily is getting a great education with RVA. She is challenged and she's not bored. She enjoys her classwork.
I love the teachers. The teachers are the best part. My teachers are very friendly and they're easy to reach out to when I need help with an assignment. The teachers are always there when you need help.
What I love about RVA is the flexibility, first. But second is that Tiger Lily is so happy with this school, with her teachers, and with what she's learning. It's awesome.
Forward being a mutual, it's a great opportunity for customers that bank with us because it allows us to make decisions for the long term, for our community, for our customers, and for our employees. We're not driven for profit, as most companies are. So we can make decisions that are good for our communities, our employees, and our depositors, and that's very unique.
Welcome back, everybody. It's second quarter, and you got a front row seat. Here's the
Hamer.
Snap. Hamer bursts! Yes,
and still
he's
going.
Still fighting! Won't go down!
Wow!
He's going to be about a yard and a half short of the first down, but a big burst by Hamer there.
Number
second
six,
down.
The number six steal, ceiling. So that's Kyle
Hamer
ceiling.
Hamer on the carry brought down by number six ceiling. And that's going to be a couple of yards short of the first down marker. Second down.
How many ceilings we got? We seem to be just saying ceiling the entire
time. What a big family
29,
by the ceilings. You know, that must be
six,
a fun Christmas.
Right?
That's all football. I got to say. Meyer under center, and he's going to hand it off to Healy.
Coming around
he's
going
to try to loop it around the corner. Gets a couple of blocks, and his legs are going to do the rest. Tries to bring it back into the inside, and he's brought down at the 20-yard line. Big run by Healy.
72 Haney on the tackle. That's a long
and
way for the defensive line.
Right,
yeah,
Healy's slow to get up, but he does get back up. First down, Colby.
Healy
on the carry, he's going to pick up the first down and much more. First down, Colby. Brought to a stop by number 72,
Haney.
Healy's coming out of the game. Going to take a little bit of a rest. Hamer's going to get the call. Tries to bounce it to the left. He does. Breaks loose. He's going to run to the corner. 29 trying to cut him off.
Ceiling can't get him to.
Touchdown, Colby. What a run.
Nine had him, just kicked his leg back, was able to keep up his momentum, runs into the end zone.
Wow, did he shred that guy? You know, so you're right, Will Mack had him with the arm, but you know, Hamer has those tricky hips, and then he just shifted his momentum and he went flying.
Is that a technical term? A tricky hips.
He has tricky hips. So Wheezy under center. I don't even know who snaps it. Snapping it. Here's a hole, and it's up, and it's good.
Looks like Hoppy snaps it.
Hoppy with the snap. There you go. 10 minutes and 51 seconds remaining. Colby adding on to the point totals. Red Hawks 0.
15,
Colby
20,
21.
30,
we're going to go take.
We could get it. I'm sure it's on YouTube.
Welcome back, everybody. Colby just scored again. They got a new all-star running back in the backfield, Hamer, making a name for himself here.
There is going to be so many puns to use, like
Hamer time.
Oh, maybe just one.
That's the only one to use. It's Hamer
there, like,
time.
Sledgehammer.
So. Oh man, Brost. They call him
Stoner
Megatron,
and Ceiling back to receive. Ceiling's going to take this one out.
Yeah, no Keeling. Ceiling finally gets one that he can bring back. Runs it to the far sideline. Tries to get a block. And
wow.
Gets stopped.
Voss on a huge tackle on the corner.
About the 22-yard line, and that's where Redhawks are going to get set to work.
He did not see Voss coming. I didn't even see Voss coming.
Number six, Ceiling. Bring it back to kickoff. And gets it to about the 24-yard line, and that's where he's going to get to work. First and 10, GET. Brought down by Voss.
Where is Mateo? Here's
Zero.
The snap.
Stoner. Tackled
Stoner
by Rue.
Middle, and Rue and Rotz, I believe, on the
Rue
stop
wrapped
there.
Him up. Rotz just kind of pushed his hands on top of his shoulder pads.
There
Rue,
you go. A couple
Rue
of yard gain right there. Second down.
Stoner on the carry. Brought down by Rue for a second down for GET.
I don't see where is he?
Mateo's out there. He was jumping to and fro. He's wearing pants.
See. Here's the snap.
Quarterback
and
keeper.
It's going to be an end. Yeah, he's going to loop it around on the far sideline, and he fights for that first out, but he's going to get denied. Just shy. Big gain there by the Redhawks.
Big stop by Martinez.
Yeah, no kidding. He made sure that he wasn't going to get to that first down marker.
It's close, though. Martinez on the tackle.
Kids on the carry. Martinez on the stop. Third down and short for the Redhawks.
Redhawks getting right back to work. They're just grinding and pounding it out. They run into some resistance, but they got some really good blocking, and they're just finding that yardage. So let's see if they can pick up that first down right here. It's going to go up the middle, and he bounces it to the outside, and he's going to get that and a little bit more. That'll move the chain gang.
Two
Redhawks going to get a fresh set of downs.
Schindler on the carry. Rotz.
Schindler on the carry. Rotz bringing him to a stop, but that's going to move the chain gang. First and 10, GET.
I wonder if they like GET or Redhawks. I don't know. The Redhawks is
I was willing to say Gale Ederick Trempolo, and I still will do that. But a few fans said, no, just say GET. They've been staying in that tight
Flip
formation.
Flip back to Ceiling.
And they're going to push the pile, and it's still pushing. Hornets trying to bring down the runner after a really hard-fought four-yard gain there.
That doesn't
Second
look
down.
Like much fun. Rotz is on the bottom of that pile. Ceiling, number 29.
Number 29, Ceiling on the carry. Finally gets brought down by pretty much the entire defense at that point. Second down.
I'd give it to Rotz. He was on the bottom of the pile. Like, literally four people deep.
He it was me first, man.
He came up. He didn't look like he had a good time underneath there.
GET looking to see if they can get on the other side of the 50 into Hornet territory. First up! Past the 50, and they are in Hornet territory. Just
Schindler
like that.
On the carry. Healy on the tackle.
Schindler on the carry. Gets it into Hornet territory. Finally brought down by Healy. First and 10, GET.
Wow. Hey, Redhawks, they've been running
hey,
all
year. Hey, you get
them
tired enough.
They're
That's,
not going to
yeah,
quit.
Yeah, I agree. Keep running up the middle. They'll get tired eventually.
It's going to get mixed agent number two, and he's going to pick up solid yards. That's a big burst for about a solid six-yard gain.
Schindler on the carry.
Give it to Voss.
Voss on the initial stop. Second down.
Yeah, they're swinging it off that right side, just kind of coming up, having the whole line push, and they're getting 4 or 5 yards every single time.
You know, it's a good formula. You know, just keep pushing the pile. Keep pushing the pile.
Yeah. It takes a lot of time off the clock.
Yeah, speaking of which, we're nearing a 7-minute marker here at halftime. It's going
to
be a
pitch back to Ceiling.
Ceiling, and he leans over the 40-yard line just short of the first down marker.
Stuck around the backside there and was able to grab him before he made it to the first down
marker. Number 29,
marker.
Ceiling on the carry. Rue. Tries to lean for
for that first down marker about a yard short. Third down.
Rue on the tackle.
Rue on the stop.
That might be Kobe's new defensive position against this, is that they get around the backside there because they're only blocking up front and trying to push the entire pile, and they're leaving the backside completely vulnerable. So Rue's coming around the corner. The problem with that, you swing it to the outside one time. Stoner on the carry.
Stoner goes up the middle again, and he's going to blast past that first down marker. Another first down for GET. Looks like about like stitching on the initial stop
Rotz,
there.
Rotz hit him first, and stitching and fell on top of him. But
yeah,
Rotz is going to come out after that one.
Agent Zero, Stoner on the carry. He's going to pick up that first down, brought down by Rotz. First and 10, GET.
Rotz is favoring his knee. Hopefully he's okay. Here we go, first and 10, GET.
Quarterback keeper coming around the right
and
side.
And Ceiling tries to spin his way to
Domer
gain some extra
on
yards.
The tackle.
But yeah, Domer's going to bring him to a stop. About a two-yard gain. Looks like they're going to spot him at the 35-yard line. Second down.
Two on the carry.
Schindler on the carry. Brought to a stop by Domer. Second down.
Here we go. Working steadily into Hornet
territory
the for the Red Hawks.
Coming around the outside.
Schindler can't
gets
bounce it.
Spun out by Wheezy.
Good stop by Wheezy. Big third down.
Schindler tries to bounce it to the outside. Gets roped down by Wheezy. Third down.
That was a big stop because at that point, every gain by the Redhawks was a positive
That's
gain.
That's a good call, though, by GET. Like, they've been pounding that middle. They're going to get a big play on that outside. That's where that's going to come out because they're crashing on the outside to come get in the backside of that pile there.
Try to run from everybody. Schindler, it's the same play. He's going to go on that side again.
Voss on the hit.
Gets about 2 or 3 yards on the carry for a fourth down and manageable.
Voss on the tackle.
Schindler on the carry, picks up a few yards right there. Fourth down for GET.
Yeah, that's a Voss on the
Voss
tackle.
Voss on the stop.
It's a solid 6 yards here. You know, obviously you're obviously going to go for it.
Combine is streaking down Highway 13, and he's not going to get stopped.
Unstoppable.
Why is there a combine on Highway 13?
It's just moving between fields.
Oh, it's a chopper. Sorry. Timeout called.
Oh, they're going for the hard count.
Call.
Oh, Rotz did go back in.
Timeout White, get their first start, timeout of the half.
All right. So, somebody's going to get tired running this ball up the middle. Like, one of them's going to get really tired.
This
so, mattering on how GET is, if they've got the same kids on their offensive and defensive line, because obviously they must have some really big kids up that front line for their offensive line, somebody's going to get really tired. And this, it's either they're going to start scoring on either one of these sides, because this is unsustainable. Like this, they're pounding and pounding and pounding and pounding and pounding. And both of these teams, we've thrown it like, what, once tonight?
Meyer.
Yeah, one pass. It was on the outside there to, he got clipped down right away, one of the kids. But somebody's going to get tired here. Like, it's, we're going to see some big plays here in this third quarter is what I expect.
I would say so. Fourth down. It's going to be a pass play. Ceiling sings it over and a pass is completed.
Ten.
Owen Eddy with a big reception, and that drive is going to stay alive.
Wheezy on the coverage.
Schmitz drops back to pass and makes a connection to number 10, Owen Eddy, and that's going to pick up the first down. First and 10, Redhawks.
Fantastic play call there.
And it's
right
going to be
up the,
up the middle and
number
not
two.
Much going right there.
Schindler.
Schindler not going to find much daylight.
Hit initially by Rotz.
Rotz is all over the place.
He is all over.
Schindler on the carry. Rotz on the stop. Second down.
You want to find somebody on the bottom of the pile. It's going to be Rotz.
Yup.
Guy's got the nose for the ball.
He is hearing the call to stuff that middle gap, and he is answering. Second down right here.
Coming around, quarterback keeper.
And it's going to be ceiling. He's going to go around. He's going to step.
Gets past Rue.
Gets past another.
Robita trips him down. Ball fumbles out.
The ball gets on the ground.
Healy's got daylight.
There's no flags. Healy's got a wall of blockers, and he's going to jog his way at the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Colby. Oh, my. What just happened?
Touchdown is what they're calling.
There are no flags on the play.
Fumble recovery by the Colby Hornets, and Caden Healy scampers into the end zone. Touchdown, Colby.
He was looking for that extra yard. Like, he had his nose down. Like, all
what
he had,
happened?
So he was trying to get that extra yard. He was falling forward, and he tried to make a spin, but his head was down low enough, and as he got hit, he spun backwards. The ball came flying out of his hands.
Oh, man. You know, man, you want those kids, you have to take those extra efforts, though. You know what I mean?
Well, but you have to. Like,
man,
that's what you're that's
snap
what you're
is
for.
A little high. Bros boots it through anyway, and the kick is good. And that's going to add on the point totals. Less than 3.5 minutes away to halftime. Red Hawks, they're in a 28-point deficit against the Colby Hornets. GET 0, Colby 28.
It is always surprising on how we're off.
I absolutely feel that Tiger Lily is getting a great education with RVA. She is challenged and she's not bored. She enjoys her classwork.
I love the teachers. The teachers are the best part. My teachers are very friendly and they're easy to reach out to when I need help with an assignment. The teachers are always there when you need help.
What I love about RVA is the flexibility, first. But second is that Tiger Lily is so happy with this school, with her teachers, and with what she's learning. It's awesome.
All right, Bros getting ready to kick off here. We've got Stoner and Ceiling back to receive.
Oh boy. That's rough. Here's the kick.
See if he puts this one back in the end zone.
And is it going to go through the uprights? No, just falls short of the field goal. Goes into the back of the end zone, and it's going to be a touchback. GED going to start at the 20-yard line.
Do you think he gets kind of bummed when they actually bring it out, or do you think he's aiming for that end line to make it as long
Burrows
as possible?
Burrows takes it into the end zone. Touchback brings the ball out to the 20-yard line, and that's where the Red Hawks are going to get set to work. Here before halftime, 3 minutes and 29 seconds remaining. First and 10, Red Hawks.
So the last drive, very successful for GET. They didn't come out with any points off it. They make it all the way down to almost the 20-yard line. But it takes them about 6.5 minutes to get down there, or 3.5 minutes to go before halftime. Do you come back out throwing? Like, you almost have to, right?
Like, even starting at this point, you have long yardage ahead of you.
Well, granted, you don't want to throw an interception this far down, but you're almost going to have to speed things up.
Well, here you go. Wait, they're spreading them out.
All right.
Agent Zero goes into motion.
Quarterback keeper right up the guts.
Up the middle.
Rotz got him.
Colby not fooled. Only a 1 yard gain right there. Second down. What? 2 yard gain. Second down.
Schmitz on the carry.
Rotz on the tackle.
Rotz on the stop.
Rotz has been an animal.
He has. He's been watching.
Playing like somebody said, hey, go get a haircut.
But granted, like, it's a real bunch formation. Like, the ball's coming, you know, very few times that swung to the outside. It's pretty much up the gut, and that's where he lives. Like, you're running into his house.
Tight formation again here, and it's going to be
right up the gut.
Off the middle. Hard to see with this
Stoner
bunch formation.
Got it.
Yeah, Agent Zero with the carry, and no, about Stitchin a yard gain. Third down. Stitchin bringing him to a stop. Third down.
Oh, my goodness. Stoner on the carry.
Stitching on the tackle.
Third down.
Precious time ticking away here. Tick, 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 tick. Red Hawks looking to see if they can get something going here. because you know what? You got to try to at least get your offense into
right,
firing
a full
range
minute
right
down
there.
Now, and you've only got three plays run so far.
You know, that's
or two plays run.
That's the next thing, Wade, that brings up. It's like you don't want to give Colby any kind of time right here. Whoa, four wideouts.
It's a pass. Maybe.
Schmidt rolls out, tries to fire into the sideline, and it's incomplete for Ben Hilton. Tight coverage right there, and it goes incomplete.
Hilton was the intended receiver. Robita on the coverage.
Schmidt tries to pass it over to Hilton, but it goes incomplete. Bring it up fourth down.
Did we discuss how fast Robita on the coverage?
Robita on the coverage.
Did I tell you how fast Robita was running on that?
18 miles an hour.
I know. So, like, I don't know if I'd throw at him on coverage.
Cheetah speed.
Well, like, cheetah with three legs.
Yeah.
Speed. But still, 18.8 miles per hour, that's pretty quick. If, you know.
And
White, their second start timeout of the half.
You heard the man.
At Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, we are here to help you with your local home needs. Whether it's your first house, or your dream house, or your last house, Fairway is here for you. We care about our customers because they are not only our neighbors, but our friends. We are a locally owned mortgage company, and we pride ourselves on helping better our community and our customers. If you would like to learn more about your home options, please give me a call today at 715-384-7878.
Hey everybody, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
Countdown's over, and you're back just in time.
It's
here's
a pass.
A step. It's a fourth down play. Schmitz.
Broken up by Watts.
And it's incomplete. Wow, the pass was on the money for Schindler, but it goes incomplete.
Rotz got a full hand on that.
Big play by Rotz.
Yeah, Schmitz to Schindler. Right?
Yes, yep.
Schmitz tries to get the pass to Schindler, but the pass is broken up by Rotz. Turnover on downs. First down, Colby.
It's a calculated risk to get all the way down. I don't know.
You know what? Would you have punted?
I would have punted on that one, but that's hindsight at this point. Like, you've got to score some points. Got to take some risks.
What? Against who? Oh.
Healy. Bumped behind the line of scrimmage.
Oh, Healy gets the carry, makes
still
a
going.
Guy miss, tries to tiptoe the sideline, and he's going to be out at the 20-yard marker.
Chased out by Peterson, number four.
Peterson chasing him out, saving a touchdown right there.
Healy on the carry, gets chased out of bounds by number four, Peterson.
Yep. Looked like it was going to be like an 8-yard loss there. He got initially hit behind the line of scrimmage and ran backwards.
Yep. Hey, real quick, St. Croix taking on Bloomer. St. Croix, 22. Bloomer, zero. There's a score update for you. Here's the snap.
Hamer right up the middle.
Hamer up the gut. Not much going.
Runs into a wall
gets
of everyone.
Gets stood up. And everybody's pushing. Not much going right there. 55 on the stop?
Yeah, I give it to 55. Two was right next to him, but 55
Hamer
is probably the one who's
the
got him.
Robertson. By number 55, Robinson. Third down.
It's taking time off. A minute 30 left here.
There's a lot of time.
I don't know if there's a lot of time. They're sitting on, what, the 15-yard line?
Here we go. Here's the snap. Meyer gets flushed out of the pocket and just throws it away. Throws it at the feet of Hamer just to get that ball away so it goes incomplete. Fourth down.
That was a broken play. There's no way they would have not blocked to that corner there.
It goes incomplete. Fourth down.
I think this is field goal makeable. Is it from Bros'
Well,
range?
What would that be?
So you've got 10 yards deep, so that'd be 10,
kick.
20, 35? 30, 35-yard kick.
Maybe. I think so. So here we go. Here
yep.
comes Colby.
They're
they
gonna
got
go for it.
Hamer in
fourth
the backfield. Healy off to the left, Rue off to the right. Meyer's going to get the ball, and it's going to be a handoff to
right
Rue.
Right to Rue, hit behind the
and
line of scrimmage.
Not much going. Big
55.
Stop by number 55, Robinson.
Robinson, fantastic tackle.
Rue on the carry. Robinson stops him in the backfield. turnover on downs. First and 10, GET.
Perhaps the strategy by Colby there was like, hey, you know what? Let's just take some time clock off. Because, like, even if we kick this and we make it or miss it, that's going to give them more than a minute. So maybe they were trying to hope for something there. But you kind of wonder if they could have kicked for that.
I don't know. You've got quick snap.
And
comes around the corner.
Well, he's still scampering. Finally gets
quarterback
jumped
keeper.
On top by Domer.
Healy got him. Domer jumped on top of him.
Carry. Domer on the stop. Second down.
Wait, what? What's going on here?
Timeout. Their first start time out of the half.
It's a weird haze coming over the field here. I wonder where this, it's a long line of smoke here, or else it's a low-hanging cloud here. But being in town here, it's an odd, odd cloud formation.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Maybe it's coming from the concession stand. Maybe that's delicious cloud burger dust.
All right, let's see a dance off here, GET. Let's see a dance off, Colby. Everybody knows that song.
See, much, much more popular with the crowd.
Yeah. Let's see. If you're in Northern Central Wisconsin and Farmland, is Billie Eilish going to beat Cotton Eye Joe? Nope.
Not a chance. Nope. Never mind.
I like the Billie Eilish song, and I think it's kind of funny that another artist sings about another artist. I find that hilarious. There is an eerie song.
I'm telling you, it's like the haunted trail around here.
No kidding.
It's a pass.
Schindler.
Going for
back.
The bomb.
Drop.
Doesn't see it. Meyer on the
man,
coverage.
He's got the arm, and it drops down at the 35-yard line. He's got a big arm.
Oh, Ceiling stopped about halfway through the route and was looking up, looking through the fog. Ceiling? Couldn't see the ball. Ceiling, yep.
Schmidt fires a bomb deep downfield.
For number six.
Number six, Ceiling, but it goes incomplete.
Meyer on the coverage.
Meyer on the coverage.
He probably couldn't see it through the fog. Like, the haze, the ball probably just disappeared. Poof.
Now you just need to hear, like, you know, like those boats that make the fog noise. No, the buoys. or maybe we need, like, a lighthouse. Here's the snap.
Quarterback keeper
Schindler
coming around the corner.
Out.
Martinez
gets
finds him.
Stopped. No daylight found. Martinez just knocks him down. Fourth down.
Timeout. Three. Their second start timeout of the half.
Schmitz on the carry.
That brings up fourth and long here with a minute left to go. Punt formation. Knox back to kick.
High snap, big punt. Doesn't get blocked. That's always a good thing. Drops
no
at the 50. Takes a big Red Hawk bounce.
Rolls out of bounce around the 35, 36, 37.
36-yard line. That's where Colby's going to get set to work with 44 seconds remaining.
Big punt. Takes a big Red Hawk bounce. And it's going to land around about like 36, 37-yard line. That's where Colby's going to get set to work. First down, Colby.
Oh, here, I thought there were some geese flying over.
I can't hear geese. Neil, do you hear any geese? Yeah. Quack,
some
quack.
Geese flying through.
Yeah, you guys are crazy. We don't hear anything.
Yeah, like goose. Colby is going to try and bring this one out.
Robita on the near sideline. Here's the snap. Handoff goes up to Neil. To Healy, breaks free. He's going to try to see if he can get past 29. 29 ropes him out of bounds. Touchdown saving grab right
by
there.
Ceiling, number 29.
By Yeah, that was Brady's ceiling. Big stop right there by Brady, but a big game by Colby.
Healy on to Gary, gets the ball into Red Hawk territory. First down, Colby. Gets roped down by Brady Sealing.
It's going to be a pitch swing back. Out. Oh, and it gets pitched to Robita. Meyer out.
Meyer trying to block out there.
Robita
gets a good block.
Trying to razzle dazzle, and he picks up some great yards.
52 are the fantastic
he's got
tackle.
Some big, he late. Ran about 40 yards to get 12 yards. First down, Colby.
Robita on the carry, Lakey on the tackle.
No time. Hagan doesn't want to hear the announcing. Handoff goes to
Healy.
Healy waiting for some blockers. Gets
got
it.
Daylight.
Running into the, oh, just past the 5-yard line.
Tripped up by number 10.
Time.
Owen Eddy.
Still tick. Well, time is briefly stopped. 14 seconds. Once they spot the ball, yep, now it goes. 12, 11, and a timeout is going to be called. Stuff is going so fast, nobody knows what's going on.
Timeout, White, their third and final.
Oh! GET's like, we got to talk about this. We can't give up another score. 11 seconds remaining.
I think Kobe's arguing for the other
put.
2 seconds to get put on there.
We are going to stay put. Wow. Holy smokes, Wade. They are just marching down the field.
I'm surprised that they took that much time off the clock before that initial timeout by Kobe. I think that's what Hagan's out there arguing on.
What is he arguing?
So there was 14 seconds left as they were trying to spot the ball, and they were frantically calling for timeout here on the sideline here, and 3 seconds got pulled off the clock. You know, after they spotted the ball.
I
think
so
he's
he
arguing for
those
3 seconds.
Back.
But I don't know if he's going to win his fight. So it looks like there's going to be 11 seconds to go here before half.
So Coach Hagan was my middle school teacher, or middle school. He was a middle school teacher and high school vice principal. You do not want to see him angry. Or
he
it's the first
a
down and goal.
For you?
Meyer,
it's a pass. Meyer's open to Wheezy.
Wheezy! Touchdown, Colby!
Meyer fires a dart to Wheezy! Touchdown, Colby!
Wow, what a sequence. Hornets running fast and hard. It is the first half, 8 seconds to halftime, and the Hornets 34 against the GET. Here's the snap, a little bit high. Bro says, I'm okay with that. And the kick is up and it is good. 8 seconds remaining here until the halftime. The Red Hawks 0, Colby Hornets 35.
Oh. Yikes. Sonar and Ceiling back to receive. Brost on the kick.
Bang! Brost kicks it really high into the
oh,
smoke.
Oh, they're
going to
bring it out.
It. Wow. Why are they calling it there?
I don't know.
Oh, I see. So Kyle Ceiling had his foot in the end zone, and that's why they're going to call it a touchback.
No, he must have made a signal before the catch, because he can still bring it out of the end zone.
Kyle Ceiling gets the kickoff, and they're going to bring it out to the 20.
The timekeeper, please put 8 seconds on the clock. 8 seconds.
You heard the man. So, GET is going to line up. Either going to try to do a razzle-dazzle play to see if they can get extra yardage, or they just might call her quits right here.
No, if they wanted 8 seconds, they're going to do something.
they're gonna
pitch back to Stoner,
and he tries to go up the middle, and Stoner gonna move the pile. Wow, big blast of a 5-yard gain, but it
Domer
is going to end that way.
Stoner on the carry.
Domer on the tackle.
And that's gonna finish out the first half. Two more quarters to go. Your score: Red Hawks 0, Colby Hornets 35.
So where are we, Neil? Are we still here?
Are we here?
Okay. So here's the thing. Holy cow!
Wow.
What a turn of events. Colby was kind of feeling a little bit down on themselves after that Auburndale game for a low scoring affair and a six point loss. But oh my word, 35-0.
That's
and there's another half to go.
Yeah, and for the offensive, defensive, both of them have been running. It's been run heavy. Somebody's going to come out really tired in the back half. Like, so the score is only going to go up for either one of these teams significantly in the second half. I wouldn't be surprised if GET comes out throwing on this second half.
You know, almost think they have to.
I'd stay away from the bombs. I'd throw something a little bit shorter off. They
Wade's
had success
a big fan of that.
So really, 5-yard outs. That's the way to go.
Now, were you middle school or high school football?
I played freshman year, and that was enough for me. I went back to volleyball. That's the gentleman's sport.
There was no high school volleyball at Colby, though. Well, you played.
I went over to Eau Claire, yeah.
Yeah, so Wade likes the short passes back in his football days, but they are highly effective. Like we even saw with that touchdown score, the latest one by the Hornets, where, you know, they sold GET on the run. I was expecting the run, and
exactly.
Meyer just throws it as hard as he could for a 2-yard pass to Wheezy, and Wheezy literally is just standing in open space like...
It's the repetition of everything. We're running, you're running, you're running. Throw a pass in there every once in a while. Nobody sees that stuff coming. Nobody even wants to cover because everybody's trying to get in on the pile, especially for the success that GET was having on throwing Stoner in there, Ceiling in there. They'd make 5 yards on every carry.
Yes. Why not?
Why not? I don't know.
Well, so far... There's a few things that I would like to say before I get to these scores. I just got
I thought you were going to go right to them. There's a few things I'm going to say that are written down right here.
One, that Schindler and, hey, okay, that Schindler, heck of an athlete. Oh, sorry.
Oh.
Schindler, heck of an athlete, and man, Robinson.
I was going to say number 55, yes.
Big defensive guy. And I guess on the other half for Colby, just looking at this thing, what a huge surprise with Hamer. I mean, I knew he was a good running back, but man, like, granted, Healy was, like, streaking up and down the field, but, like, Hamer is, like, that breath of fresh air for that Hornet offense when Healy needs a little bit of rest.
Well, and figure he's probably got a little less wear and tear on him throughout the season off of it, and he's got seemed to have
beyond
really good
legs.
Balance. You know, he's got initial... yards after contact has been really, really high off of him. You know, he's been bouncing off, you know, a few of the extra guys here.
So, you know, you have the other thing that's been kind of like, I guess here's the other narrative that is going on with this game so far. Colby not just making advantage of those turnovers by getting the ball back. They're scoring as soon as they scooped it up.
Yes. Well, you can tell that that must be heavily practiced off it because the moment that ball came out, granted there's confusion, you know, everybody's looking around, where's the ball? The moment someone starts running the other direction, there's 11 guys running the other direction. Everybody joins in. When he walked into the end zone, you know, you're like, oh, I'll get a few blockers here. It was the entire team.
It was the entire team. So, like, now that was something that I was mentioning of toward the tail end of last year's Colby team when they went to state. What was different about that team was the downfield blocking. For a while, you know, you don't really, Wade pointed that out, you don't see a heck of a lot of that. When somebody picks up the fumble or the interception, usually there's kind of like a delay. Like you said, there's confusion. Nobody knows what's going on. But yeah, what's been different the last three seasons with this Hornet squad is, you're right, that is like inundated in their programming. As soon as they see a jersey turn the other way, they're running along with them, and they're going to be looking for something.
There must be some sort of sprints they have to do. If, like, somebody gets caught on film not running the other direction, oh, you got to run during practice because everybody's running.
Now, the one thing I would say, though, like, I don't, if the score is lopsided, but, you know, if you're GET, you're not out yet. There's a lot of football to play yet.
There is absolutely.
Especially if you have a team that's built for this ground and pound offense that they have, where they're bunched in tight and they're just pushing piles, you got to understand that their program, where they're not going to wear out as fast as like somebody would expect.
No, so and I would say they've been doing this all season with this many kids too. Like they've got a full roster here. If you've been running and that's been your bread and butter all season, granted you're going to be in pretty good condition.
Yeah.
You know, for the entire season, and they've faced pretty large opponents there, having some of those first place teams that they've focused
exactly.
it on for their own conference.
So I guess if you're wondering, like, okay, well, if you're GET, you're sticking to that running game. I wouldn't go away from that running game. I guess
throw,
I would still
throw
like
the ball. I got to throw the ball a couple times.
Yeah, don't give up on that Owen Eddy. That's one of the big receivers.
Right.
And then that Brady Ceiling. That guy, you get him in open space, I really think he could turn on the Jets. I'd like to see him in open space a little bit more. So, anyway, well, I got a pamphlet here. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
So here's some scores. It's halftime. Auburndale is in level one play, and they're taking on Fall Creek 19-0 at halftime.
And what division is that?
Six.
Six, okay.
Yep, Auburndale's not in our division. Stratford is taking on Cumberland. Stratford is getting their stadium rebuilt, so they are playing not
at Cumberland?
No, they're
playing at
Stratford. At DC Everest. That's their home away from home. So they're at DC Everest, and that's halftime. Stratford 41, Cumberland 0.
Do you know the nickname of Cumberland's, their city motto or their city nickname?
No, because we played them in playoffs a few years ago, and we were talking about that. Is it something with beavers?
Nope.
I don't remember.
That's Augusta. Cumberland is the island city.
Oh!
Because when Wisconsin used to be a shallow ocean, when we used to be further down, closer to the equator, when Pangea was moving around, Cumberland was never underwater.
Oh.
It's a weird fact. There is no crustacean. There's hardly any limestone up there. It's just west of Spooner. That's a fantastic volleyball community. I used to go play volleyball there all the time when I lived up in Spooner.
Shout out to Cumberland.
I love Cumberland. Cumberland is one of my top favorites. The island city.
Island City.
Love that place.
You know what would be kind of fun? We should all just go visit there. We'll take on Focus with, and we're just gonna do a city tour.
I agree. We should just travel around the state. Tell you fun facts about all these little cities.
Let's go to fun facts with Matt and Wayne. So, all right. So now at St. Croix Falls, at St. Croix, Bloomer gets on the board. St. Croix Falls 22, Bloomer 8. Edgar taking on Turtle Lake. At Edgar, it's halftime. Edgar 22, Turtle Lake 0. Man, there's just a lot of lopsided scores. And with that being said, here we go. At Assumption, Pittsville is taking on Assumption. At Assumption, it's in the second quarter. Pittsville 18, Assumption 19.
Oh!
They are
what a fantastic game.
Let's cheer on those Marrowood boys. Come on, Pittsville. And finally, let's see here. In the second quarter, Regis taking on Pacelli. And Regis 51, Pacelli 0. Yeah, so there's that.
There's that.
Wow. So there's some scores for you, for all you football fans out there. If you're tracking some other teams, wondering what's happening in Division 5, Division 7, and Division 6. And there you go. That's what's all going on. So right now, the Colby Band is playing some pep band music. GET is out on the field with this spooky smoky haze going on right now. Neil, are we still good on time? I think we should take a commercial break because I got to tell you, I need a shot of water. And every time I drink some water, it's loud. So if you don't mind, I'd like to take a few commercial breaks and we're gone. Oh.
With 100 years of working experience, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Whether you're looking for a new home, recreation land, or a place to start your new business, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Stop into either of their convenient locations on West Broadway Avenue in Medford or North 4th Street in Abbotsford, or find them online at c21dairyland.com to find out more. Century 21 Dairyland Realty, a proud supporter of local athletics.
Hey everybody, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC, and I'm standing here with Brian, our medium duty sales manager, and he's got some exciting news for us. Brian.
Well, we've picked up the Western snowplow line as of the first of the year, And we've got our first order here of plows, sanders, and salters. We'd love to talk to you about what your needs are for this winter. Give us a call.
At Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, we are here to help you with your local home needs. Whether it's your first house, or your dream house, or your last house, Fairway is here for you. We care about our customers because they are not only our neighbors, but our friends. We are a locally owned mortgage company, and we pride ourselves on helping better our community and our customers. If you would like to learn more about your home options, please give me a call today at 715-384-7878.
Living every day to the fullest, giving hugs and laughing loudly, bringing joy to those you love. Vaccines set us free to live openly. Schedule yours today.
I was looking out the window. I'm like, where the hell are the geese?
Hey! Good job today!
Big congratulations to the Colby Hornets girls cross country team. They competed at sectional today, and as a team, they finished second. And they will be advancing on the stage.
Thank you.
All right, we got.
You had a good snack, and you got a you got something cold to drink, because we're back underway. And oh my gosh! And the 30-yard marker eats the dust. Ball's gonna knock it in the face, and that is going to bring out a penalty flag. It looked like a three from up here.
Gross kick makes a connection with the 10-yard marker. And that's going to bring first and 10 GET.
35.
Man, it really looked like the 30-yard marker.
30. Ooh.
All right, here we go.
Short kick.
GET looking to see if they can get off to a positive start with
quarterback
field
keeper
position. Schindler!
Rotz and Voss got him.
Not going to find anybody, or not going to find any yardage. They're just going to find green jerseys.
Schmitz on the carry. Quarterback keeper.
What was that?
Quarterback keeper. Quarterback keeper is Schmitz.
Rats on the stop. Second down.
Do that to me. Just let me say the wrong name. God.
Schindler.
I'm trying to say a name, and then Wade has to blurt it out again.
Well, it's not the right name.
Wade, I'm writing this down in our production notes. Oh, all right. My word.
No corrections. He's throwing
Schmitz.
It. He's open.
It up, oh. And wow, that was a really good play there. I wouldn't give up on that one. That was
Sorensen.
It goes incomplete.
Meyer on the cover.
Schmitz drops back to pass, trying to find Sorensen, but it goes just incomplete.
Meyer on the coverage. Among
third
others.
Down.
I like it. I love the play call. He had him just a little bit too far out in front of him.
Yeah, he had to lead him just by a little bit. Number four coming into the ball game. That's Ben Peterson. Says, hey, guys, it's time to go. Now we go.
Yeah, where is number four? We haven't
Holy
seen him
Holy smokes,
all.
Four wide receivers all on the left-hand side, near sideline. Number two goes into motion. Schmitz drops back to pass.
Zamora gets away from Zamora. Ball's out. Colby recovers.
Ball hits the turf. And it's going to be Colby Ball.
Martinez on the recovery.
Holy cow. First down, Colby.
Schmitz drives back to pass and tries to escape, gets a ball knocked out of his hands. And it's going to be a turnover to the Hornets. First down, Colby.
Zamora blew up that play, was able to get around Zamora, but as he came around, knocked the ball out of his hands.
Holy
recovered by Martinez.
Cow.
Hamer right up the gut.
Hamer goes up the middle, runs past the referee, and he's going to get brought to a stop at the 10-yard line.
It's
first and goal,
Hilton.
Colby.
Hilton on the stop, Hamer on the carry.
Hamer on the carry, brought to a stop by Hilton. But it's going to bring the Hornets to the 10-yard line. First and goal, Colby.
Oh, it is inside the 10-yard line.
Gets a little bit quiet. Here's
Hamer
the snap.
Again.
Hamer's going to try to swing it and try to get past some defenders, but it's just not going to work out. And it goes right back to the line of scrimmage. Second down for Colby.
Jimenez on the tackle.
Hamer on the carry.
Jimenez, number 70.
Jimenez on the stop. Second down.
Number 70, Jimenez.
Jimenez.
Yeah.
That's how they told us.
That's literally how he told us. Jimenez.
Well, sorry, honey. Coaching staff, Urseps. Anyway, shotgun formation. Hamer goes into motion.
Quarterback keeper.
And Meyer's going to swing it on the right-hand
oh,
side.
Oh, blown
wow,
up by number two, Nate Schindler.
By Schindler. And he was awfully proud about that hit.
Yes, he was.
Meyer on the carry. Schindler on the stop. Third down.
Schindler doing a little bit of jaunt.
Yeah, friendly little jaunt
Dang.
Outside. Yeah,
Look
that was
me.
A good stop.
I can push you down.
Bonk.
Robina on the near sideline, only wideout. Pitch to Healy, gets a block. Tries to scamper away from some defenders. Spin move, tries to lean over to the 5-yard marker, but he's not gonna pick up much.
Ceiling on
That's
the tackle, number six.
Fourth down at about the five, yep, right on the 5-yard line.
Ceiling on the tackle. Healy on the carry.
On the carry.
Ceiling
bringing up to a stop, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
Schindler went for the big tackle on it, missed him. Fell right down. Number six comes and tackles behind him, and you just see him, he comes up, he's just shaking his head.
Oh, he
just
wasn't John
him.
On that one.
No. Field goal. Here we go, Brost.
Brost lining up for a three-point attempt after getting stopped short of the goal line.
Looks like a 20-yard try.
Big defensive stop here by the Red Hawks.
No
and the
good.
Kick is no good. Well, there you go.
I wonder where it went.
I'm not sure, but it went into next week is where that ball went.
Huh. It must have been too far to the left.
Field goal attempt by Brost is... No good.
The guy on the far side called it. So it had to have gone on that side of the goalpost. It looked like it was through from this angle.
The Red Hawks offense, first and 10 GET.
That was like a weird sequence right there, because it had to have been far left then, huh?
Yeah, it had to have been far left there, because he really, really pounded that ball, and it looked like it went through, but yeah, must
Schmitz
not have.
Pitches it.
Stoner.
Agent Zero tries to blast up the middle.
Healy on the tackle. Stoner on the carry.
Yeah, 6 or 7 yards on that blast. That's going to bring up a second down and manageable for the Redhawks.
Stoner on the carry. Healy on the stop. Second down.
Hey, now that worked out well for the Redhawks.
Yes, it did. That was a good stand.
Get a turnover.
Stoner again.
Big stop. Miss extra point
attempt.
Behind
the line of scrimmage here by Voss.
Voss blasts up the middle and hooks up with Stoner. And, yeah, not much going there.
Stoner on the carry. Brought to a stop by Voss. Third down.
Colby Hornet defense looking to see if they can get a quick three and out. Try to get that offense back onto the field. Receiver is on the far top. He's going to come into motion. Handoff goes up the middle. Flag is thrown.
Ooh. Schindler on the carry.
That was number two, Schindler. And looks like he was brought down to a stop by...
It could have been Wheezy there is what it looked like. There was, like, Rotz on the initial hit. Wheezy pushed him over. Flag on the play. Like, I'd give it to Rotz is who I'd give it to, but Wheezy pushed him over. Looks like it's going to be a holding. Going the silent treatment on that one.
Penalty on GET, and that's going to be a repeat of third down.
Yeah, I wonder what happened to the mic pack there.
Yeah, I don't know.
Why no mic pack?
Well, you never know. Well, brings up third and long for GET.
It's a third down and long, and we guys wonder if this is going to be it's going to be a pitch to the outside, and wow,
nowhere
to go. Wheezy! And Rue gobble him up.
That's Ceiling on the carry. Wheezy Ceiling and Rue on the
carry.
Tackle.
Rue and Wheezy on the stop. Fourth down.
Oh, huge loss in that play. Deep pitch. Coming around the outside was Wheezy and Rue.
Wow, Hornet defense buckles down after that miscue by the Hornet offense. And the Redhawks looking to see if they were going to bounce back after that one turnover that they had, but just couldn't do it. So now they've got their special teams out there.
Maybe you got Rue and
look at the punt.
Robita back to receive.
And it's going to go towards Rue's way, and he's going to catch it. He's going to try to field it. Gets hit by a defender, bounces
Ceiling
off him, and then comes to a gentle stop at the 35-yard line, and that's where the Hornets are going to get to work.
Rue on the reception. Ceiling.
Rue fielding the punt, gets it to about the 35-yard line, and that's where the Hornets are going to get to work. First down, Colby.
Brady Ceiling on the tackle.
Mr. Brady Ceiling on the stop. Mr. Brady, give me a dream.
29.
Rue on the far, or on the near sideline. Robita at the top.
Healy coming around the corner.
It's going to be a handoff to Healy. Tries to swing it to the outside. He got a couple of blockers, but not much else. Second down for the Hornets.
It's Jimenez on the tackle.
Healy on the carry.
Number 70.
Jimenez on the stop. Second down.
By what? I know. It's not Dez. It's Jimenez. Jimenez. You know the routine.
All right, Hamer in the backfield.
Bunch
Rue in the
formation.
Corner.
It's the second time we've seen that tonight. And
Rue
it's going to go
around
to Rue, and he goes on the left side. Big spin move. Gets a block by Wheezy downfield. And he drags a pile.
He tried to pull the ball out late. He was
and
literally laying
it's
on the ground.
At the 20-yard line, but the ball came out late.
Yeah. One
and
ripped out the ball as Rue was laying on the ground. No, he was down.
Well,
yes.
They're conversing
the sideline
for an awful long time. And it's going to maintain a Colby possession. And
Well, that is the right call. I know that it's hard to see from the side, but I was watching that whole thing with the binoculars. He's laying on the ground. One came over after he hit him late.
Ruan
pulled out
Harry,
the ball.
That's going to pick up the first down. First down, Colby.
Meyer under center now. Here's the handoff and goes to Healy. And, geez, he just gets just stomped by that defensive line. No gain on the play. Second down.
Lakey, number 52 on the tackle. Healy on the carry.
Healy on the carry and runs into that defensive front of the Redhawks. Lakey on the initial stop. That's going to be second down for the Hornets.
You know, give mad props here for the Redhawks. They are buckling down hard once the Hornets are deep into GET territory.
Hamer right up the middle.
Hamer gets the call. Side jukes, spin moves, still trying to spin away. Finally gets brought down at the 6-yard line.
That'll be enough for a first down.
Burst up the middle by Hamer. First and goal for Colby.
Hamer on the carry, Will Mack on the tackle. 9.
Hamer on the carry, and he inches it closer to the 5-yard marker. First down, Colby. Brought to a stop by Mack.
Mack. Tight formation right here, and it's going to go
coming around the
to
corner.
Healy around the corner. Zamora
picks up a really
loose,
good block.
Runs into
wow.
the end zone. Touchdown, Colby. There you go. 16 seconds remaining here in the third quarter, and the Hornets strike back.
Healy gets some blocks and finds the corner end zone. Touchdown, Colby.
Look at that handsome play.
Should have been bigger. It's pretty
small.
Made
by Premier Printing, based in Marshfield, Wisconsin. Whether your job is small or big, and it needs to be colorful for all your printing needs, Premier Printing, fast, timely, and professional. And there's a play on the play. You're hired. Yeah,
false
I bet he'll love
start
that one.
On the Hornets, it looks like.
False start, Hornets. Start the clock.
He's really not wanting to do anything with that announce.
Bros is going to line up to kick it once more.
Yeah,
Weezy
arm swing.
Gets the call.
They're like,
says, are you okay? Well, I'm okay. Here's the snap. Ball's down. Laces out. Dan goes up to the upright.
Finkel's
a
man.
Good. Maybe the laces were out on the last one.
Our experience in the RVA has been wonderful. The teachers are extremely supportive, and Simon really seems to enjoy it and is making friends, and he's more socially active now than he was in a traditional school.
Something I want other kids to know is that even though it seems like you're not going to make friends, you actually are. I like how the RVA provides an environment that more suited to my needs.
Clinner Insurance, we know you want to protect your business. The Clinner Insurance team will help you choose the insurance package and plan that fits you and your business. At Clinner Insurance, protecting your business is our top priority.
Stoner and Ceiling back to receive for GET. Brost on the kickoff for Colby. Line drive towards Story, fumbles the ball.
Ball comes out of his hands, picks it back up. He's running for his life now and finally gets brought down.
61 on the tackle. That's Fuentes.
Fuentes brings him down to a stop, and who received that?
Stoner.
Stoner on the carry.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Stoner gets the kickoff, and he gets brought down by number 61, Fuentes. And that is going to be the end of the third quarter. Three quarters in, one more to go. Here in our Division 5 Level 1 playoff matchup, your score, Redhawks 0, Hornets 42.
With 100 years of working experience, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Whether you're looking for a new home, recreation land, or a place to start your new business, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Stop into either of their convenient locations on West Broadway Avenue in Medford or North 4th Street in Abbotsford, or find them online at c21dairyland.com to find out more. Century 21 Dairyland Realty, a proud supporter of local athletics.
Our experience in the RVA has been wonderful. The teachers are extremely supportive, and Simon really seems to enjoy it and is making friends, and he's more socially active now than he was in a traditional school.
Something I want other kids to know is that even though it seems like you're not going to make friends, you actually are. I like how the RVA provides an environment that more suited to my needs.
Just enjoying a little bit of jump around because, you know what, why not?
Why not? Beautiful night here. Good weather.
Absolutely.
It's an odd fog yet, though.
And it's, a bit of trickery, number 29 is bringing loose. Brandon Sealing, he's got space. Robina's trying to bring him to a stop, and he's going to. Wow, and just like that, in a flash, he gets it out into Hornet territory at the 45-yard line.
Where did he come from?
In space. And we got a Hornet player down.
Cramps.
Cramp watch, 2023.
Yep. That gets a pickle
2022.
Juice. I'd be curious if you got that recorded. I'd love to see what actually happened there because I missed the ball too.
And he puts on the Jets and brings the ball to the 45-yard line. First and 10, GET.
That was quite the trickery. I really thought Stoner had that ball coming around the corner.
I couldn't see where that went. That was unbelievable.
So the quarterback came around. He spun around. Stoner came around the backside of it. I thought he just flipped it to him. So he must have gave an inside handoff to Sealing coming around that backside.
Uh-oh. So some players are coming out. So, yeah, the players are like, hey, listen. Oh, and it's Logan Stitchin, and
uh-oh.
He is not.
He's not putting any weight on that foot. That is not a cramp.
Down.
That is going to be a big loss for Kobe up in the middle there. He's playing offense and defense.
Yeah, he's pretty big on the offense and the defense side. He's a big kid. So they're going to see if they can do something with that foot.
There's something going on there.
As we get back to play here, we're in the fourth quarter. One more to go. 11 minutes and 46. 36. You know, these contacts, when they dry out, they're really hard to look through. Anybody got some moisturizer?
LASIK. Oh,
and it's
going to
be
out of
reverse. Stoner, find space. Oh, my gosh.
Hamer's
Martinez
on for zero. No, that was Martinez.
Martinez grabbed him by the belt and dragged him down.
That was his fingers.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, he had him by the fingers?
Fingers. Literally the fingers.
Stoner springs loose and hits just by his fingertips. Dropped down by Martinez. Big first down for the Redhawks. First and 10, GUT.
I bet three of his fingers are like an inch longer now. Like, literally, he got pulled down by his fingertips. Man, I bet that hurt. Oh.
GET is finally
Sealing
rolling.
Coming around the corner.
Brady.
Rue on the
rolling
trip up.
And finally gets rolled to the ground. Rue and Robita bringing him to a stop, but not before he gains himself 9 yards on the play. Here come the Redhawks.
Yep, Soder on the carry. Rue on the tackle. Rue on the tackle.
And Robita on the stop. Second down.
Logan Stitchin is still stretching that leg a little bit. Looks like he'll be okay. Shotgun formation for GET.
Stoner's got the ball.
Stoner goes in motion, and he's going to get the pitch.
Ooh.
And here comes Schmidt. Eli Schmidt with a great open field tackle. Stoner with the carry. And he's going to pick up the first down.
Stoner on the carry. He's going to pick up the first down and brought down by Eli Schmidt.
Wheezy had him behind the line
first
of scrimmage.
Red Hawks.
And just got pulled, like literally just tackled.
What happened?
So Wheezy had him behind the line of scrimmage and just got tackled. Like tackled. Like holding tackled.
Oh, so there's a holding call on that one.
Yeah, he was
He was informing the ref of that one. Quarterback keeper right up the gut.
And that's Schmitz up the middle, and he's going to rope his way toward the end zone, and he is...
Robita on the tackle.
Whoa, just short. Just stopped by his shoestrings.
Schmitz on the carry.
Schmitz on the carry and just short of the goal line.
Robita on the tackle.
Robita on the stop. First down, GET.
I'd expect a Ceiling to get this ball right up the gut. They seem to have the most push when he's behind the line.
Yeah, you got Ceiling and Schindler in the
backfield.
He's going to
two.
And
he's going to make it in.
Schindler is going to make it into the end zone. And that is the score for the Redhawks. Touchdown, GET. There you go. Things are rolling now.
That's right. Good answer
and
by GET.
Goes to number two, Nate Schindler, and he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Redhawks.
Not the Redbirds, but the Redhawks.
There's a lot of actual Redhawks up there. I used to have to do Redhawk surveys up in that neck of the woods.
Redhawks or Red-tailed Hawks?
Red-tailed Hawks, but yeah, they're still the Red Hawk.
Well, a red tail. Well, okay, it has the name Hawk and Red in it, but technically a red-tailed hawk. Not that the whole hawk is red.
It's mostly red.
That's true. Well, a burnt orange. Maybe like a rust.
More of an amber color.
Oh, it's going to be a pass!
Wide open
a
Ceiling.
Athletic grab!
Ceiling
brought
on
down by
catch.
Brady Ceiling. Great pass by Schmitz. And that's going to, the extra 2-point conversion is good.
2-point attempt is good. Schmitz finding number 29, Brady Ceiling. And 8 minutes and 38 seconds remaining here in your ball game. Redhawks get on the scoreboard. GET 8, Colby 42.
It's a good answer. They started that drive with 11 minutes and 39 seconds. Make it down there in basically two good minutes coming down there. Or three
Absolutely.
Minutes, actually, I should say.
So on that defensive series, we saw quite a few people, second string defense. So like you even see that right now. We see Smith, number three, is coming out there along with some of the main string guys. Actually, this is kickoff. I think they are usually out there. Never mind.
Yeah. Yep, this will be special teams. Like Hamer's out there. Rods
Eli
is out
Schmidt
there.
Was out there.
Healy's out there. They got the hands team right up front expecting an onside kick here.
Ah, absolutely. Robita way in the backfield saying, like, I dare you to kick it to me. And then we got Voss midsection.
I don't know if I've got to see an onside kick yet this season.
This will be exciting.
This will be exciting. So I assume they have to line.
Is...
No, they
Whoa,
don't.
Whoa, that's a crazy kick! And... Recovered at
By
the
Hamer.
50, so it's, yep, Hamer's going to get it, and they're going to count it.
GET with an onside kick attempt, and Hamer jumps on top of it. Ball's going to be spotted at the 50-yard line. First down, Colby.
I'm surprised that in high school they let them bunch formation like that, that they don't spread them out.
Sure. Yeah, it is kind of weird, isn't it?
It is.
So, Hayes, we have a new quarterback coming in. That's Smith. That's Tate Smith out there. The crowd's trying to sing Sweet Caroline. I love it. And
Smith's
he's
coming around
roll
the corner
to his right, or his left, and boom. Brought down at the 45-yard line. Or just short of the 45.
I'd give it to
line.
Will Mack on the tackle, number nine. Will Mack.
Smith on the carry.
Will Mack, number
Will
nine.
Will Mack on the stop, second down.
If you say fast enough, it sounds like Sumac.
Sumac.
Got Geiger and Voss in the backfield. Tate under center.
Tate
Voss
hands it off
corner.
To Voss, and he's going to spring to the far sideline. Makes a couple
he's got
guys. Smith moves past another tackler, and he's fighting his way towards the 10 and finally dragged to a stop at about the 14-yard line. What a downhill run by Voss. Big first down gain for Colby.
Mattson on the tackle, number 25.
Voss springs loose and drags his way towards the 15-yard line. First down, Colby.
Number 25, Charlie Mattson.
25, Madison on the stop.
Mattson? Madison? Mattson? Mattson. pulling precious time off the clock here. Down to 6 minutes and 26 seconds here for left in the game.
Colby looking to see if they can put a little bit more points on the board with second string offense out on the field.
You got Orthmeyer
Smith
coming around the corner.
Keeps it, swings it around the left-hand side, fights his way, following a block by number 61, and he's going to get brought down at the 5.
Smith on the carry, Shoe on the tackle, number 31.
Who?
Shoe.
Shoe?
Shoe.
Smith on the carry, Shoe on the stop.
That was Moises Fuentes? Yeah, Fuentes, number 61 on the lead block there, gave him a few extra yards.
Geiger
first
and Voss.
Down and goal for Colby.
Voss coming around
goes
the corner.
To Voss on the far side. He is going to play on the Jets. Touchdown, Colby.
He is quick, man.
Voss gets to the outside and puts on the Jets. Touchdown, Colby.
That's about an 8-yard run.
Holy cow. Colby just blew this. Not just wide open.
Wide
big
shut.
Wide open. Yeah, he blew it wide shut.
Oh, we got a new field goal kicker here. Camargo. Ooh. Good hold.
Kick is up, and it is good.
Camargo on the extra point. 15.
5 minutes and 34 seconds remaining here in your ball game, and Colby strikes back. Redhawks, 8. Colby, 49. You want my sweatshirt? It's in my bag. Oh, sorry, you have it on. Oh, I'm sorry. Only two. So we're back, I believe.
Yep, we're back.
So Brost getting set to kick it off.
Stoner and Ceiling back to receive.
There we go. And
ooh,
Brost
got
is going to kick
one.
It. He is going to kick it into orbit, and it goes into the back of not in the back of the end zone, but pert near. And that is where it's going to roll to a stop.
It's the warmer weather. It's really making that football fly. It was not flying that far last week.
Gross kicks that ball into orbit. It goes into the end zone. It's going to be a touchback for the Redhawks. They're going to get to work at the 20-yard line. First and 10, GET.
So in case anybody doesn't follow us religiously, I try to play the entire song of Sweet Caroline in the fourth quarter as much as I can. And sometimes I achieve it. Sometimes.
Probably not tonight.
Maybe not tonight, but I am, gosh darn it, I'm going to try my best. Four wideouts.
It's a pass.
Schmitz drops back to pass, tries to find Peterson.
That's
and
Will Mack
incomplete.
On the pass. Will Mack was throwing that ball.
Will Mack?
Yeah, number 9 threw that ball.
Oh, sorry, Will Mack on the pass.
Will Mack drops back to pass, tries to find Ben Peterson, but it goes incomplete. Second down.
I need new contacts. Whatever these contacts are.
Not these.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. If you're looking for a new pair of contacts,
his
do not get these.
His last name is Mack. His first name is Will.
Golly.
Will Mack. Well, that's his name. Throw it all together. Will Mack.
Four wideouts again. Will Mack dropping back the pass.
To Bob.
Bob's a deep downfield to 14, and he comes out with it. Eli Schmidt on the coverage, but holy smokes.
Sorensen.
Elijah Sorensen brings it down at the 50.
Timeout.
Will Mack drops a dime
to Eli Sorensen, number 14.
Sorensen for a big gain. Ball will be spotted at the 50. First and 10, GET.
Shout out to our police force. Oh, another combine on fire. Oh no. A what? Oh, jeez. Who won?
There's only losers in that scenario. Nobody wins in that scenario. Deer loses, you lose. Like that raccoon on the way into town. Everybody loses on that one.
GET got a little bit of life left here with the waning moments of this ball game.
Will Mack back to pass.
Will Mack swings it around, breaks loose, fires downfield, and the ball is tipped and just out of the hands of Owen Eddy. Man, it was just right there.
So Sin had the first shot at it, and Eddy had the second shot at it. He had him. It was just a little
Will
high.
Mack tries to connect, and the pass is deflected and almost grabbed by Owen Eddy, but it goes incomplete. Second down.
It was deflected by his own guy, the intended receiver.
Oh. Like, well, it's funnier this way.
14 wanted it, yeah. Oh, we're going to get another pass. Very excited.
Sticking with the same formation, and why not? Got to try to get another score. Will Mack drops back. Hit as he throws. Incomplete.
Pressure, number five. I believe that's Geiger.
Brady's ceiling was wide open. That's why he looks a little bit frustrated.
Geiger on the rush. Or the initial hurry.
As he throws, getting pressure by
Geiger, number 25.
Geiger! Third down.
Screenplay. Screenplay. I'm calling it right now. Screenplay.
Wade wants a screenplay.
I do. The initial rush
off. You know what? Here's the thing about screenplays.
They never work.
That's what won the Packers the Super Bowl in 2010. And why the Packers haven't been doing screenplays since, I don't know. Unbelievable. Mack throws it.
Oh.
And it was just like you said, a screen pass. And whoa. Number Schindler and Meyer getting into it a little bit. And that is going to be a fourth down.
The receiver.
Pass intended for Schindler, and it goes incomplete. Fourth down.
Think so? Think that was going to go to Schindler?
I don't know. That's the best I could see. Well, you know what? I'm just trying to do my best. It's not like this is an ESPN tape I'm trying to submit for an audition.
Right. Yep. We're unpaid amateurs out here just trying to give the benefit to the crowds here as we're
and a timeout
volunteering
is called.
Our time.
Timeout called.
Hey everybody, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
Are you ready for a faster and easier mortgage process? Tap Lending combines the speed and efficiency of technology and people and a great local bank. The perfect combination for your mortgage.
You know what's really funny is Neil gave us the signal that we're back. He put his thumbs down. You know what that means.
You're welcome.
GET in a tight formation right now, and the ball is going to go to Brady.
Ceiling,
and he's got a block. Gets past Vigut. Dodges another runner. Stays on his feet, and he gets out of bounds, but a big, big first down gain there.
Enough
by
for
GET.
First down, too.
Yeah, big play right there.
Brady Ceiling breaking through some tackles, and he moves that chain gang. First down, GET.
Hoppy had the best shot, or Vigut had a good shot at him. Hoppy had the best shot.
Vigut got past
him. Just kind of chased him out of bounds there. Well. Minute 54 left. Coming around to Stoner.
Go to Stoner. Big spin move. And Eli finally brings him down.
Stoner on the carry. Schmidt brings him to a stop. Second down.
It's a good carry. About 6-7 yards on that one.
And what is this?
Time out, GET.
Time out call. The song comes at a special request. This goes out to Central Fire and EMT.
Their favorite song.
This is their favorite song. When they're putting the hose on the fire hydrant.
That's right.
This is what they're listening to. When they got to scrape that dead deer off the road, they're saying, I'm hooked on a feeling. Oh, man. We'll play that one again. That was good.
just more of Uka Chaka.
So they got, it's still the same quarterback play here by Mack. Swings it out. He's got a lot of real estate. Schmidt is just standing in front of him, and he stops him cold. But it's going to be a big gain. Redhawks looking to see if they can get a double-digit score here against the Hornets.
First goal.
Will Mack calls his own number. And gets stopped short of the end zone by Eli Schmidt. But it's going to be a first and goal, Redhawks.
Redhawks want this bad, and why not? Here in the final moments of this Division 1, Level 1, or Division 5, Level
keeper.
1 play.
Will Mack calls his own number.
Into touchdown. The end zone, touchdown, Redhawks.
Will Mack calls his number again and gets it to the end zone. Touchdown, GET.
I thought they would be more excited, but they weren't so happy. 41 seconds remaining here in the ball game. GET gets back on the board with 14 to the Hornets 49.
Going for two.
What's going to be the song we play when this game is over? Four wideouts on the top side.
It's a pass.
Slings it out, and he fights it to the end zone. Touchdown. Not touchdown. Two-point conversion is good.
Schindler. Miniature
Schindler
touchdown.
Schindler gets in there.
Will Mack connects with Schindler and scampers into the end zone for the two-point conversion. 41 seconds remaining here in your ball game. Redhawks
16, Colby 49. Sorry. Are we still here, Neil? Okay. So we're playing Hooked on a Feeling, Wade. And the Central Fire love this song.
I believe it.
So they're putting up that fire hydrant. They're hooking the hose onto the fire hydrant. They're like, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, trying to get that. No, when they're filling the water trucks, that's what they're screaming. Hey, quick score update for you, Wade. St. Croix Falls really taking it to Bloomer, 36-8. So it looks like St. Croix Falls is going to wrap that up. So if we were going to be presumptuous, which I'm going to because we're in the waning minutes of the game, Colby's next opponent's going to be St. Croix Falls. And St. Croix Falls has a number one seed. And that's what it looks like Colby is going to be facing next week. GET, this is their first playoff appearance since 2019. They've had 25 all-time against Colby, which have been in 16 playoff appearances in a row, 28 total. And it's a pooch. And Smith falls on it, and he says, I'll kneel this one. 37 seconds. Or I guess the time is going to tick it. Never mind.
Smith takes the kickoff, kneels it down, and about the 45-yard line. First down, Colby.
I was teaching
the volleyball girls, the pooch shot in volleyball, none of them have ever heard that term before. Not even in football, they've never heard that word before.
You know what I would say? We're canceling the season.
how can we need a larger vocabulary here. And that will do
it. And that will do it. Four quarters in, four quarters out. Division 5 playoff will continue for the Colby Hornets. The great season for GET unfortunately comes to an end here in C-Town. Both combatants are congratulating each other. What a great game. Two running juggernauts faced each other, but the Colby Hornet defense and running game ended up muscling out a win against the Red Hawks. Momentarily, we're going to go find the Century 21 Relentless Player of the Game. We'll bring him up here for an interview, and I'm going to get on the PA system. Neil, do you want Wade to keep talking? Nope, we're gone.
Hey, everybody. So, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
Thank you.
With 100 years of working experience, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Whether you're looking for a new home, recreation land, or a place to start your new business, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Stop into either of their convenient locations on West Broadway Avenue in Medford or North 4th Street in Abbotsford, or find them online at c21dairyland.com to find out more. Century 21 Dairyland Realty, a proud supporter of local athletics.
Okay. So is this on for them? All right, cool. So when you guys are going to talk, you're going to talk like this. All right? So, hey, everybody. Hey, everybody. Matthew Olmekin here. And for Century 21's Relentless Player of the Game, we got two of them. So right here, we got your running back, Ivan Hamer. Ivan, right?
Yep.
Absolutely. And then we also have your receiver, kickoff returner. I'll help you. You just let go. Here we go. I'll help. Speedy guy with really sticky hands, Nathaniel Robita. So, guys, what I'm going to be asking you here next is you're both Century 21's Relentless Player of the Game. You all had some instrumental plays and big plays. So if somebody wanted to start out first, why don't you guys take me through that game? What were some of the things that you guys were focusing on to really kind of contain this explosive running game of the GET Redhawks? Here, I'll let you have it.
Get pushed back, and also I guess stopping the run, because they didn't really pass that much except for right at the end.
No, absolutely, and it almost seemed like, you know, that was kind of like, that's all that they had kind of like going for them, because you guys were pretty much well containing them, and you would say like, yeah, maintaining that line of scrimmage was number one. Mm-hmm. So, all right, well, and then I guess another question would be is like, maybe offensively, and you both can share this, what were some of the things that, was there anything that you were focusing on more, or was Hagen kind of like, you know what, we're going to stick to our bread and butter offensively going into this ball game?
So, all the guys in their division, they mainly run spread offenses, so we're just going to stick with our bread and butter and just run up the middle every time, because they're not used to playing that. And like, the one team that does play up the middle a lot, they really hit them hard for like going through like the two hole or eight hole. They did a really good job against them, so we're just going to stick with what we're good at.
Now, how did that, you know, so like you came on later in the season here with Lopez kind of being out these last few games. Well, how did that feel? Like, were you kind of like, oh, or were you pretty excited?
Well, I was pretty excited, obviously, but I was also very nervous, even though, I mean, it's basically the same thing, nerves and excitement.
So now, here's a question I'll ask you, and this just came to my head. You have this very fluid style. It's very Lopez-esque. Not saying that you're like Lopez. You're obviously your own runner, but, like, when you do your runs, you don't really, you're not like Healy where you're putting the head down. You kind of like, I don't know, take me through that.
Well, it's probably mostly instincts when I'm just running the ball. And I'm mainly, like, I don't like to just, like, stay flat and straight run the ball, because I really like to watch my blockers and see where they're all at. And even on, like, the sideline, somebody was telling me that I run a bit weird when I'm running
see,
the ball.
That's what I mean.
Like, I'm kind of, like, running around people and not really, like, hitting them. But I don't know. It's just, I just do it.
It looks like you're used to getting chased by little kids. That's what it kind of looks like to me. So here, going to Robita now. Opening kickoff. Take me through that whole play.
Ooh. I guess all started with me getting the ball right in the middle. And right away, I saw a hole right in the middle. And I guess I just went for it. Healy was in front of me, get another lead blocker in there, and then he took a dude and ran past him, I guess.
score a touchdown.
When did you know you were going to take that to the house?
I guess I didn't know until right after I got past the last person. So I'm guessing the kicker.
Not until I got into the end zone. That's when I knew I was in. So I'll ask you both this question. When did you guys feel, not only did you get the momentum, but you kept it? Like, that you knew that Colby had this game in hand. Not in hand, but you knew the momentum was on your side.
That first half. Yeah. That first half was amazing. It's probably one of the best halves that we've had in a long time.
Well, not just because of the point score, but what else made that first half amazing?
We all got our blocks.
Yeah, we stayed on our blocks so well.
So, was there anything you did differently between that Auburndale game and this game?
Just practiced harder.
Okay, gotcha.
Practiced a lot harder.
So you got on your blocks and you maintained your blocks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when you guys were in the group. So probably after like those first couple of series, that was when you're like, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So now going into the next level here, you're going to be taking on St. Croix Falls. And like you were mentioning when we were walking up here, it's like, well, these are going to be schools that I don't think Colby's ever played in a long time. So what are some things that you guys are probably going to be working on going into this next week to get some play or to prepare for that next level for a long road trip?
Honestly, I feel like we do a little better on the road just because on the bus we are there and we're focusing. We're focusing on the game and having no distractions.
Would you concur with that?
Yeah. On road games, we have a lot more time to stay focused and just listen to our own music and really just get ready for the game.
Interesting. Well, that's really interesting. Yeah, most teams would be like, well, we wish we were home, but you guys actually like getting on the road.
I mean, we like both, but can't always have both at the same time.
That's true. So when you say playing music, what's the music that all of you guys are listening to?
Auburn music is very different for each player. Like when we play music in the locker room, some songs, like some guys will hate, and like other people will be like dancing, or, well, not dancing, but like bobbing their head and stuff.
Oh, I gotcha. What about Shawn Mendes?
Not before the game.
That's after.
That's after the game.
Why is that a thing? Who started that whole playing Shawn Mendes thing after games?
It was just always a thing since I was a freshman, probably him too.
No kidding.
We just always, like, if we ever had a good win, we'd always play kind of like cheerful, girly music or whatever. And it, I mean, it just gets you, it gets you in a good mood.
Yeah, it gets you in a very good mood.
Oh man, that's good stuff. Maybe one last question for road trip stuff. What are some other stuff, besides a music list, what are some other stuff that you guys do to kind of prepare, or like, what else do you guys prep your, or not prep, bring on with you on those like bus trips? Like, is there, like, I got my lucky socks on, or I got snacks packed?
Probably the snacks. The coaches make sure we have some food when we're doing away games, well, far away games. Yeah, we have like some subs.
Couple hours, then we'll definitely get something to eat before.
So what's, who packs the weirdest snack?
Honestly, I have no idea.
Oh, nobody has any weird snacks? Like Skittles or beef jerky?
Beef
jerky
like is good.
Well, I mean, okay, all right.
That's not
beef jerky's
weird.
Not weird.
That's not weird.
That's true.
Or Skittles.
Well, what's a more popular snack that everybody packs?
Probably just like bananas, apples.
Well, staying healthy.
Stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
I like it. Staying healthy. All right, guys. Last question. I ask everybody this one. You'll get cleaned up. You're gonna go home. I imagine you're gonna go right to the fridge. What's the first thing you're grabbing out of that fridge?
Chocolate milk. But if I don't have that, I know I bought a Pedialyte. And I'll probably drink that.
And you're just going to drink Pedialyte?
Why not?
Nothing to eat?
Depends on how I'm feeling.
Well, how are you feeling right now? What are you going to go eat right now?
Ooh, that's a tough choice. Wow. I'm either going to go to KT or find something in my fridge.
Okay, there you go. I like it. All right, Gamer, that fridge is open. What are you grabbing?
Well, I'm probably going to shut the fridge and go right to the pantry and grab a nice can of SpaghettiOs, to be honest with you. Eat it straight out of the can. I mean, it's just,
you're not even
just what
eat
I
it
do.
Up?
No, I like it right out of the can.
You animal.
It's just what I like.
I like eating
non-heated food too. Like if it's leftovers, I'm eating it cold.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool. All right, hey, you got Hornet fandom watching live from all over the place. What are some anything you'd like to say to them?
Yes. Thanks for supporting us. We really appreciate it. Hope you keep supporting us in the following years.
Yeah, keep coming to the games. Even if they're like 2 hours away, just keep going and supporting us.
So that's a big thing, right? You love it when that fan base is there. Like, it really sets the tone.
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes us feel at home.
So you hear that. Grab your green and gold and hitting the road. So this is Ivan Hamer, Nathaniel Robita, and they just got done with victory over GET. They're going to be traveling on as the number 4 seeds to take on the number 1 seed St. Croix Falls on the road. And thanks a lot, guys. You're Century 21's relentless players of the game. And what do you want to do next? Yeah, we'll do some post-game. Don't go anywhere.
Are you ready for a faster and easier mortgage process? Tap Lending combines the speed and efficiency of technology and people and a great local bank. The perfect combination for your mortgage.
Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
At Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, we are here to help you with your local home needs. Whether it's your first house, or your dream house, or your last house, Fairway is here for you. We care about our customers because they are not only our neighbors, but our friends. We are a locally owned mortgage company, and we pride ourselves on helping better our community and our customers. If you would like to learn more about your home options, please give me a call today at 715-384-7878.
Clinner Insurance, we know you want to protect your business. The Clinner Insurance team will help you choose the insurance package and plan that fits you and your business. At Clinner Insurance, protecting your business is our top priority. Clinner Insurance.
With 100 years of working experience, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Whether you're looking for a new home, recreation land, or a place to start your new business, the team at Century 21 Dairyland Realty are ready to help you. Stop into either of their convenient locations on West Broadway Avenue in Medford or North 4th Street in Abbotsford, or find them online at c21dairyland.com to find out more. Century 21 Dairyland Realty, a proud supporter of local athletics.
Hey everybody, Nat over at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC. And it is truck season, which means big savings. That's right, rebates are back. Stop on in and talk to one of our specialists, but we're focusing on the 2.7. Going on now behind me, we actually brought in a Chevy trainer to talk about those wonderful features of the 2.7 engine, and we want to be able to tell you all of those. Stop on in and talk to one of our sales consultants and hear about the great rebates going on now at Wheeler Chevrolet GMC.
Absolutely feel that Tiger Lily is getting a great education with RVA. She is challenged and she's not bored. She enjoys her classwork.
I love the teachers. The teachers are the best part. My teachers are very friendly and they're easy to reach out to when I need help with an assignment. The teachers are always there when you need help.
What I love about RVA is the flexibility, first, but second is that Tiger Lily is so happy with this school, with her teachers, and with what she's learning. It's awesome.
Okay.
Yeah, now we can hear. Yeah, now we can hear.
Wait, we got to restart that? Apparently we were muted. Now I have time to collect my thoughts of trying to do something.
Now we go. Now we go.
Not a full-time employee. So this is Matt Novikin for the Hornets Nest sitting alongside Wade. And, hey, here's your post-game recap for our Level 1 Division 5 playoff game. GET came in here. High-octane running offense against the stout defense and dynamic offense of the Colby Hornets. And, wow, Colby Hornets came out big, 49-16.
Yes, yes. Came out swinging right out of the gates.
And running. Opening play, very first play, GET, they do this little punch thing. Then they spread everybody out, kick the ball. Robita takes it, finds a seam, and like he was saying in our interview, gets a key block by Healy, and he takes it to the house.
Yeah, that literally set the tone for the entire game off. That if that didn't happen, I think that this game would probably have been a different outcome.
Oh, for sure. And then I would say, like, some other things that set the tone for the Hornets, and they weren't looking back, is they had a fumble recovery, took it for a touchdown, and then they had another one where the ball popped out, and Healy scooped it up, and then had half the team ahead of him blocking downfield.
Oh, yes. Yes. So yeah. Defense really, really did a good job. You know, they saw what was coming off of it. They expected a lot of run off it. They were able to pick up two fumble recoveries off of GET. But
yep.
Stopping that early offensive series for them, not even letting them get through the 50-yard line here of Kobe, really, really set the tone. And those two early scores by Kobe, it was clear sailing after that.
And Healy was getting frustrated by Auburndale last week, but on this one, GET was trying to frustrate him too, but, you know, they swung him to the outside a couple of times, and he was finding his yards.
Yes, he was. Yes, he was. So, like, Rue had a good game. Healy had a good game tonight. Hamer had a fantastic game.
Yeah, so Hamer was our other relentless Century 21 relentless player of the game, and the reason we picked him was he took on a huge role. He took on that second snap, or sometimes the first snap that Lopez would take.
Correct.
And so those are big shoes to fill. But, man, that kid, like, it's
he's
like
nimble.
He runs like a wet noodle.
Yes.
with a roadrunner for legs.
Hit three or four times, and his feet were just
sprawling all over. Like, very good center of balance on that kid. Like, he's going to be very interesting to watch going into the future here.
Oh, yeah, no kidding. So he was instrumental. So, like, when he was blasting through those interior plays, like, he was picking up 5, 6, 8, 12. Yeah, he was and he was just – he always looked fresh. That kid never wears out.
Yeah. Well, and he would have been fresh for most of the season coming in there, you know, sitting behind Lopez off of it. So that
well,
makes
that's
a
good.
Difference.
I haven't
you know,
ran for 7 games.
Well, wear and tear, you know, into the season really makes a difference on some of these kids.
Oh, for sure. I guess if we wanted to balance this out a little bit, looking at GET, their first playoff appearance since 2019, they've had 25 all-time. And so, like I said, like 2019 doesn't feel like it's a long time ago. Well, that's several seasons ago. So they had a great offense here. Like I said, like after you probably add up some of their yardage, they're just under 3,000 yards rushing on the season. And 35 regular season touchdowns. They think they picked up 2 tonight. And, yeah. So this offensive squad, defensive squad, were no slouches. But, man, the Hornets, once, like what Hamer was talking about, once they got the once they were getting blocks, they were holding on to blocks. And they just would not quit. And it just was not enough for
GET. I got your window in.
That's the hilarious part of this whole thing. She, the whole time, she's like, how do I get past this camera
I'm like, no,
and this
your
live broadcast? And she's like, but I really need to put this window in. So then Wade's like, go ahead. And there's already a window on there.
I'm like, I got your window in. And then
so
she
anyway,
brings the other window over.
So anyway, bring it back over here.
Yes. So Ceiling had both of the Ceiling boys. You know, Brady and what is it, Nate?
Yeah.
Yeah. Brady and Nate.
Well, here, both, bring that over here.
Yeah, so both of the Ceiling boys had a fantastic game tonight. The Robinson, number 55, had a fantastic game tonight. We called number 14, Sorensen, a bunch of times. He got targeted on, you know, for you know, the passing game off of there. Stoner had a very good game tonight. Hilton had a good game tonight.
Well, I tell you what. So something that we like to do is we like to recognize, like, top players on both squads. So now we're looking at the GET. How about the who is your great GET?
Yeah, I agree.
Did you like that? Or the Radiant Redhawk?
It's a tough choice. So it's going to be between, like, Robinson was very dominant on the defense. Like, the defense obviously had the most time on the field for them. Like, you should go with a defensive player. But their quarterback, number 3, the Schmitz boy.
Hey, there you go.
That's what I would pick. You know, running, you know, like, those are some hard yards, and they had some fantastic execution of some fake plays, you know, where they had
absolutely.
They had Stoner coming around one corner, and he gave an inside handoff coming over to the Ceiling boy. Like, very well executed on. Mm-hmm. Like, very, very talented. That's who I would give it to. I really would.
Well, congratulations to number 3, Cody Schmitz. Now, here's the next award. The Hornet Hustler. The coveted Hornet Hustler. Everybody wants that title.
So I wanted to give it to Robita. If we would have thrown it a little bit more.
Rope-a-dope Robita.
Yes. So he did get a few runs on the outside where they did swing one out to him. But, like, you know, his first execution on that kickoff was spectacular. That set the tone for the entire game. But you almost have to give it to Hamer. Like, you have to.
Hey-o.
Like,
Ivan Hamer.
He was spectacular tonight. Like, he didn't get, you know, most of the carries, but, like, when he got the ball, like, nimble on his feet, but, like, he made some really, really talented, you know, defensive people miss. Like, he's going to be a talent coming forward. Like, really great execution tonight by Hamer.
Now, I will throw a wrench because normally I don't throw in who my Hornet Hustler pick is, but I'm going to do one. So I'm going to go on the opposite side of the ball, and I'm going to say Isaac Rotz.
Yes, I agree. Yep.
Would be the other Hornet Hustler on the other side of the ball. It is very hard to ignore how many times that kid was at the bottom of the pile because GET's main play that was working really well for a while was let's just push and let's get our 5 yards and let's just steamroll all over everybody. And Rotz was always that one that was plugging that.
He was like the gymnast on the bottom of the pile building the pyramid every single time. Like, you're like, oh, who tackled him? Rotz is on the bottom of the pile.
Yep.
He was absolutely everywhere. But they wanted to run to the middle of the field. That's where Rotz lives. Like, and he was eating that right up.
Yeah, and there was one time where he was just like, he must have had a stinger, but then he came back
right back out.
Yes. Yeah, I think he got stepped on that one. Like, you could see him, like, he was holding the backside of his hand, and usually that happens when they get stepped on.
Yeah, because hands are not designed to be walked on.
Or tackled on.
Yeah, because there's one where the kid was getting grabbed by the fingers.
I bet his fingers are, like, a couple inches longer now. Like, he literally got tackled and spun around by his fingertips.
Ugh. You know, it puts a whole new meaning when you pull your fingers out. All
right. Yikes.
Well, so Colby moves on. So GTE's season is over. Colby's going to move on against St. Croix Falls. Somebody was mentioning before, like, oh, I remember back in our day we played St. Croix Falls, but I haven't seen that team.
I shot two feral hogs in St. Croix Falls many, many years ago. That's all I know of St. Croix Falls.
And what happened to those feral pigs?
I removed them from the environment. And we donated them to the local food bank.
Oh, because, so good things.
Yeah.
Good things. That's cool. Well, there's our connection to St. Croix Falls, I guess.
Another fun fact.
Yeah, so 2 hours away it's going to be. And I believe On Focus is going to try to travel up there to St. Croix Falls. Nobody knows for sure, but
it's only 2 hours away.
One way or away, we're going to figure it out. There you go. So sounds good. All right. Well, wait, is there anything else?
No, it was fantastic weather, a weird haze tonight. I think kind of played out for the whole theme of what's happening tomorrow.
What is tomorrow?
Tomorrow is the Haunted Trail right here in Colby School Forest.
I'm scared already.
7 to 10 p.m.
Yes. And not only is it going to be a great time because the weather is great, because we are going to be going for our higher totals than we had last year. So last year we were able to get $2,000 to the Colby Choir, and then we were able to put $2,000 into the Idea Foundation, and we donated over 600 food items to the food pantry cup there in Colby.
Wait, you're telling me that you could come here, your donation of entrance goes right to benefit the community.
Yep.
There's a production of literally Fear Factor going on out there with countless amounts of people hiding in the forest just waiting to scare you. There's no downside. And it's going to be beautiful weather tomorrow.
And, yeah, so, like, you'll be scared, but you'll feel good.
Feel good by the end of it. It's Halloween time.
Yes! Let's let the creativity begin! But, yeah, so, like, the theme that we have this year is foreboding. And the reason I picked foreboding is that we are purposely going to really mess around with your senses, and you're gonna be just like,
I've been foreboded.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. We got good stuff lined up, but no, honestly, like, it's we don't keep any money back. We give it whatever we invested into this, it stays there, and then the money that is generated off of there, we give it right back. So all the money that is spent on this stays within the community. We don't send it to an outside fundraiser. It goes right back into the district. Goes right back to the core programs. And the reason that we started giving it to the Colby Choir, biggest participants.
That's
they send
fantastic.
The, when I say, like, I need help, they send the house. So big shout out to the Carmen Wells pod over there. But anyway, yes, from 7 to 10, come to the Colby parking lot. It's going to be in the school forest, so it's at the north end of the parking lot. So you just park here. You'll see a trail of jack-o'-lanterns, so you just follow them in. And then you'll see the people lined up, and then you'll just hear screams.
It's spectacular. It's so much fun.
It is. It is. We're not going to tell you what we're going to dress up as.
No.
You got to try to get.
We'll both be there waiting to scare you.
And we're going to both be in the darkest part of the woods. So
fantastic.
You know it's going to be a good time. Well, anyway, my name is Matthew Omekin. He's Wade Omekin. And, yeah, we'll catch you next time.